Beloved one, I hope you are doing well. I want us to take a short reading from the book of Psalms, chapter 127. It says, if God's grace doesn't help the builders, they will labor in vain to build a house. If God's mercy doesn't protect the city, all the sentries will circle it in vain. It's really a senseless to work so hard from morning till late at night, toiling to make a living for fear of not having enough. Now God can provide. I want you to see this. It says God can provide for his devoted lovers even while they sleep. Now this tells us of the great things that we enjoy anytime we come into God's presence. It tells us of the blessings we enjoy anytime we are with God. And then we can do this through prayer, through the word of God, and even as we are about listening to this. So I want us to do something. We are going to like this video. So then please hit on the like button if you have not done so. This helps YouTube recommend this video out there to anyone, so everyone can have access to it. Also, by doing this, you help in the spread of the gospel and of the good work of this channel. Then don't forget to leave a comment in that comment section. Hit on that subscribe button if you haven't done so and you are new here. And then get on to the notification bell and do us the favor of tapping on it too. You were blessed and stay blessed.
If I were you, I would say amen before that scripture is open. Exodus chapter 5. Shabakota Sibriyata. Are we there? 1, 2, read is projected. And afterwards, Moses and Aaron went in, and told Pharaoh, thus saith the Lord God of Israel. Read on. Let my people go. Stop. He said, go and tell Pharaoh, let my people. I want them to go, but I need a man. I can't go and talk to Pharaoh by myself. Go and tell Pharaoh. He says, let my people go. Go and tell Pharaoh, that beast of a man who has held the lives and the destinies of men for 430 years. He says, go and tell Pharaoh. Don't go and speak as though you are sending yourself. You do not have any power in yourself. But go and tell Pharaoh, thus saith the Lord, let my people go. Let my people go. Lift up your voice and pray in 1 minute and say, Lord, whatever has held my life, whatever has held my destiny, please be serious tonight. Please. The word of the Lord. Go and tell Pharaoh, let my people go. Lift your voice and pray. Zobrakata shabari katabraskeda bash. Go and tell Pharaoh. Go and tell poverty, let my people go. Go and tell delay and hardship. Go and tell yokes and spells that have held the destinies of men for generations. Announce to them. Go and tell them, let my people. I acknowledge they are my people. Pray. There is a reason why you are praying. Zubrete kaparatosh kalabrandege basse prahaseyada. Ledesh kaprandes kaprotos subredige balatia. Let my people go. Let my people go. Sabros kabariende koshalabai. Let my people go. Zabros kato rishabarianda kapras kalabadia. Libro zozo predige shabratis kalabaria takuria sambradishila. Exodus chapter 10, verse 7. 10 verse 7, we're reading down to 10. Please hurry up, media, help us. And Pharaoh's servant said unto him, how long shall this man be a snare unto you? Let the men go, that they may do what? This is the reason why they have to go. There is a motif for liberty. There is a motif for prosperity. There is a motif for advancement. He said, let my people go, that they may go and keep it there, please, and serve the Lord their God. Then he says, knowest thou not that Egypt is destroyed? Read on. Next verse, 8. And Moses said unto, and Moses and Aaron were brought again to Pharaoh, and he said unto them, go, serve the Lord your God. But then he began to negotiate. He said, but who are they that shall go? Finally, I have been persuaded, but let's begin to talk. Who are those who will go? Verse 10. Okay, verse 9, leave it there. And Moses said, we will go with our young, come on, our future, and we will go with our old. There must be restoration, certain things that should have happened. It says, and with our sons, and with our daughters, and with our flocks, and with our herd. He said, for we must hold a feast. We are not going like fugitives. We need to go triumphantly. Are we together now? Verse 10. And he said unto them, let the Lord be so with you, as I will let you go, and your little ones, look to it. He says, for evil is before you. When you read on, he began to negotiate. He said, let's allow the men go, but leave the women. Moses said, no way, everything is going. Listen, when God saves, he saves to the uttermost. He will not bring health and leave finances. Are we together now? Many believers have an attitude of negotiating with darkness. Let me tell you something. When you mount pressure on Satan, he will release something small and let you go. And then we get carried away. Out of 10 people in your family, only one person now has a breakthrough and you are still satisfied. Moses said, no, we are going with our old, we are going with our young. You release my job, but my health is still there. They must all go. It's the same command that affects everything. Are we together? I came here angry tonight in my spirit. It's not as if some of us have not received breakthrough, but the devil has deceived us with miracles so that you can no longer turn back and see that there are other things that have refused to move. So he gave you a job, and little did you know that the child has not come and time is running. If God gave you a job, can't he give you a child? Tonight is a night of dogged insistence. Everything, if you release one, every other thing must follow. You can't release my brother's salvation and keep my father's own. This night, everything must go. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Please pay attention. He says, let my people go. I don't just need them to serve me, but a feast before me. A feast is a sign of victory. In ancient times, when they won war, they would gather the women and the young children, and the victorious men would come with the head of the king or drag him together, and they will sing, blowing the shofar. It's called triumph. It was and then all the spoils that they had gotten from the land, they would bring it. And as they began to dance, the Bible says, in the midst of multitude is the king's honor. So they will gather slaves that came from that nation, and they will come and like bow down to the king to show that we are yours now. He said, let my people go. You can never truly serve the Lord until you are released to go. I want the people to serve me, but as it is, there are situations in their lives that cannot allow them to serve me. Are we together? Yeah. So they say you have a medical condition. You can't pray for 15 minutes. You lift your voice, something hooks you. That's a Pharaoh holding you. You can't pray. There's nothing you can do. I've said it again, you see people go to pray, and the moment they stand to pray, the next thing they stop praying and they are moving around because of worry. Because of worry, they cannot pray. Financial worries, health worries. Are we together now? We prayed for a woman in Lagos during a program who had been pregnant for 2 years. How many years? 2 years. Every sign of pregnancy, but the machine shows that she's perfectly fine. Her stomach is flat, according to the machine. Is that a medical condition? No, sir. Life is spiritual. Remember spiritual intelligence. Life is what? This Pharaoh we are talking about is not just a man. Pharaoh is a spirit. He uses men just like Jezebel. Pharaoh is not a man. The man Pharaoh died, the spirit Pharaoh is still alive. And there are many people under the bondage of Pharaoh, but not tonight. Not tonight. The mighty God of Israel will arise with an outstretched arm. I told you what the Lord told me here while I was praying. He said, trust me and watch your situation turn around. It doesn't take time, it only takes faith. When you trust God, he will prove himself in a way that will surprise you. Tell my people, please sit down. As always, you have a role to play. Everyone listen to me. The role you have to play is your commitment to serving God. Listen, listen, listen. Deliverance is not for you to leave Egypt and live your life your own way at your own terms. No, sir. He said, let my people go that they may go and serve me. Listen, write this down. Service is the greatest way to provoke judgment over darkness. Service. Thank God for prayer. Thank God for fasting. Next week, we are going to start another powerful, I will be sharing with you a very deep kingdom mystery next week. Service is the greatest way to provoke judgment. The moment there was a willingness in the heart of the nation of Israel to serve God. Listen, God will not step in and break poverty in your life just because you are an adult. It's too small a reason to see the hand of God. This is where many Christians authorize Satan to destroy their lives. Are we together now? Come. You are in bondage and you want liberty. This is your place of destiny. This is where you are, Egypt. And the Lord is saying there is a condition, there is a state of heart. You don't have the power to deliver yourself, but you have the will to say, Lord, I am committed to serving you, but poverty is stopping me from buying books. I want to buy the books. Are we together? I can't pray because the rent is expired. The landlord is not a spirit, he's alive, he's a real person. He's coming tomorrow. And God says, you mean you want me to clear the way for you to serve me? God says, that's the kind of prayer that I like, Israel. Now, the challenge with many believers, hear me, and this is where we strengthen Satan. Listen carefully tonight. Our unwillingness to live for God and to serve him. Are we together? Versus his outstretched hand and his power to deliver us. God wants to deliver us, but the justification, the basis upon which his hand will come upon us, many of us disqualify ourselves because our motive for deliverance is not genuine. There is only one motive. One, let my people go that they may do what? Go and serve me. Serve me. They may go and serve me. This has nothing to do with being a man of God. Please listen. This has nothing to do with being a pastor. This has nothing to do with being a pastor's wife. Serving God is the lifetime assignment of everyone. What you call your job or any avenue is just a doorway. Let me tell you, brothers and sisters. It says, I shall not die, but why will I live? But live and declare. Live and proclaim. The justification for being alive and being victorious is a heart and a life that is committed to promoting the kingdom. You are representing him and advancing the frontiers of his kingdom. There is no devil strong enough to take your life. It says, many are the afflictions of the righteous, the Bible says, but the Lord delivered him from them. How many? Affliction is not unusual. Are we together? Jesus himself said, let us go to the other side, and he met a storm. Meeting a storm is not a sign that you are not a Christian. Jesus met a storm. On the all-knowing God said, let's go to the other side. Between prophecy and manifestation, he met a storm. So meeting a storm in your life is not the issue. The storm overcoming you and making rubbish and nonsense out of your life is where your victory becomes questionable. There are many of us here right now with all kinds of storms standing before you. Death sentences given by doctors. Some of you are holding it and wondering, can God change it? There are many of us in situations that only God in heaven, you can't even share it with human beings because they do not have the faith to believe a man can be going through this and still be alive. But there is a God in heaven. Brothers and sisters, you are gathered tonight before that God in heaven. There are men who are held in bondage. God has anointed and called them, but the doors of ministry will never open. You know why? Because many of them don't want to serve God. Doing ministry is not serving God. No, sir. Make no mistakes about it. You're a man of God here. Pay close attention. Let me show you why you keep getting disappointment in ministry. You can be anointed, praying in tongues, raising the dead, all that is stories. If your heart is not committed to serving the purposes of the kingdom, forget about all of these things. Most people want power. When you see a man of God walking in the anointing, when you see crowds, when you see all kinds of results happening in the life of a man and a ministry, many people admire, they want it. You see, God has no problem giving it, but your motive. Oh God, give me twins. God says, even if you want 10, I can give you. What is your motive? Let me tell you something. This issue of committal to serve God, this committal to follow and pursue hard after God, is a big secret. A big secret. The justification behind the stagnancy of many people and the motivation behind them leaving that place to another realm. Let my people go. Oh Lord, change my financial status. God says, I can. It is within my power. But what for? And he said, God, I'm just tired of poverty. God says, that's not enough reason. That's, if I give you too much money with no assignment, it will kill you. It will destroy you. The Bible says the prosperity of fools will destroy them. Lord, give me a crowd of thousands of people. Make me a man of influence. Lord, let people love me. Let me just be a celebrity. And God says, it's all within my power. Justify your reason. And he says, Lord, I came from a background of inferiority. God says, so what? That's not a reason for me to trust you with influence and grace. But when a man's heart becomes resolute, Lord, grant me finances so that one day I will override the building of your house. God says, you want to do this for me? And then you quote his scripture back, for the sake of thy house, I desire thy prosperity. And God says, that's it. You've satisfied the condition to see my hand. Lord, heal my body. I want to serve in your house. But the department I want to join requires energy. And Lord, I have found out that I have a medical condition that cannot allow me carry chairs. And God says, who gave you that condition? The moment anything stands between you and serving God, it has become God's enemy. It's God's own fight. Let me tell you how to join God and Satan. Use service. Let your problem follow you to the altar of service and stand back. And God says, whatever stands in the way of any man serving me has become my enemy, including a man. Are we together now? When the captain of the host of Israel appeared before Joshua, He said, are you for us or against you? He said, all that is nonsense. Whoever is on God's side is the person I'm for. If you are against God, I strike you. If you are for God, we are a team. God is not a Christian. God is on the side of whoever has the heart to glorify the Father and to see his kingdom come and his purposes established. That you're a Christian is no guarantee that you will get the partnership of God. Your heart. Is God preaching to someone tonight? Lord, I want you to launch me far. I want you to change my life. You have said it's the year of triumph. And God says it's not a lie. Brother, there is more anointing and unction than you have ever dreamt to walk in. Leave all these kindergarten visions here and there. There are superior dimensions, but your motive. You pray for 40 days, but your motive corrupts it from day one. And God says, come to a point where your heart is committed to serving me, and I will not release. Do you know, my project with God is to come to a point where God is not afraid of doing anything with me or committing anything to me. I want to get to that level of trust with God where whether the virtues are with him or with me, it makes no difference because it's all his own. Come on now. Whether that anointing is in the throne room or walking through my life, it makes no difference because it is for his glory. Tonight, hear me. It is God's desire to heal you. It doesn't take rocket science. But now when you become free and energetic, what do you do with that strength? That's the question God is asking. Lord, I used to sing well, but then I had an infection that destroyed my voice. And God says, but I've never seen you commit yourself to singing in my house and lifting up my name. And now you want me to clear that throat condition so that you go back and the devil will use your voice for nonsense. And God says, no way. You can cry, you can roll on the floor. If your motive is not intact, forget about the experience of the power of God. Are we together now? Say, Lord. Say it, everybody. Lord, I declare that as you bless me, as you heal me, as you deliver me, I vow to serve you with my life. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back. No turning back. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back. No turn. Take your hand. Cross before me, the world behind me, no turning back, no turning back. The cross before me, the world behind me, no turning back, no turning back. Men forsake me, still I will follow. No turning back, hey, no turning back. Though men forsake me, still I will follow. No turning back, no turning back. Come on, sing it before him. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back. No turning back. Hey, I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back. It's a costly assumption to assume tonight that everybody wants to follow Jesus. I've discovered that there are people who genuinely are not interested in following God. I'm not talking of self-perfection. I'm talking of a sincere committal to following Jesus genuinely with your life. No way. There are many parasites of Jesus. Financial parasites of Jesus. There are parasites of kingdom principles. They want to use kingdom principles and mysteries as a ladder to become famous. Sir, it doesn't work that way. Oh, please hear me tonight. There are people, every time you hear a man of God talk about passion for Jesus, you think they are talking about ordination to ministry. No, sir. It's an addiction to see his kingdom come. For God's sake, what else will I be doing with my life if not lifting up his name? Jesus, I lift up your name. Jesus, I lift up your name. That's what I do for a living. Jesus, I lift up your name. Yeah, Jesus, I lift up your name. One more time, lift your voice and say,
Jesus, I lift up your name.
I lift up your name. Cannot find his purposes fulfilled through your life, I tell you, forget about the outstretched hand of God. You hear me say this? Don't let any man fool you. God is not a herbalist. My brother, is your heart God is looking for? Not tithe, not offering. Your heart, not music, not just energy. My son, give me your heart. Give me your heart. Give me your heart. I want your heart. When we talk about Jesus Christ, many people frown their face as if you are speaking against civilization. The days that will come, please hear me, people of God, the days that will come will require outspoken, radical passion for Jesus. All this organized, civilized nonsense that makes God look secondary will be the recipe for the dominion of darkness over the life of people. Oh, I'm now 25 years. Don't make me look like a child. I'm now 30 years. I hope you know I'm now the director of A and B and C nonsense. And that's the reason why David danced before God. And his wife said, Abba King, keep your dignity. And David looked at her and said, hold on. You don't even know the mystery of how you became my wife. If you know it, you will join me dancing. I was a little boy with no hope, no destiny. Didn't read any book. I was a smelly shepherd in the wilderness. I danced my way beyond any king to get to the throne. And now because I am here, you carry your dignity. The Bible says God had him all, and that woman died barren. It was not the devil that made her barren. Let my people go. Not that they may go around causing trouble and wasting time and just counting age and growing older. Let my people go, that they may go and serve me. This issue of living for Jesus, serving Jesus, not let's even accepting him into your heart. There are many people, when you talk about genuine surrender, not coming out to recite an altar call, I make up my mind I am for Jesus forever, they laugh at you. They laugh at you because it doesn't make sense to them. They don't see the need. Why should I give my life to Jesus? I want to be the God of my own self. So you manage your life by yourself. I want to be the God of my own self. So you answer your prayer by yourself. I want to be the God of my own self. So you mismanage your life by yourself. It says, submit thou to the mighty hand of God. Then resist the devil and he will flee. You know, I sincerely see a lot of people, great men and women of God, who want to walk in the anointing. And I see the way they play games with submitting to the authority of Christ. You will never be trusted with certain dimensions of the anointing until God vets your passion. You can't fake it. There is a level of kingdom influence and power No, go to a herbalist, you will still not get that dimension. It takes your heart dead to Christ, not just living. This one, you have died to the purposes of the kingdom. Otherwise, you cannot carry certain levels of grace. No. The kingdom has rules. You can fake it with men, but not with God. There is a dimension, brothers and sisters, where God vets your heart and sees that Pastor Femi will live and die for me. It's not one leg in today and God is not sure of what you will become in 2019. No. Nina Yesune Basanko 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 please sit down, listen to me. Everyone inside, outside, the overflows along the road, listen. I want to make a serious altar call now. Everybody sit down and listen carefully. Let me tell you something, brothers and sisters. Coming to surrender your heart to Jesus is not an initiation into a religion called Christianity. No. Are we together now? Where you are switching founders from an idol worshiper, you were worshiping stone. Are we together? And now you say, guys, stone is not a better alternative. So I come to another founder. There are not 10 gods, there is one God. Hear ye, O Israel, the Lord our God is one God. I don't care who preaches what, there is only one God, the King eternal. We can argue it, but one day, very soon, the difference will be made clear. There are people seated here listening to me. I don't condemn you, but brothers and sisters, it's time to be serious with God. Shortly, you're going to experience radical deliverances and healings and miracles. But that is only useful when your heart is with God. I don't care whether you have been a pastor for 10 years. There are two altar calls I'm going to make in one right now. Please hear me carefully. Those following us online from any nation you're following, just listen carefully. You may not be able to run out, but I want you to pay attention and participate. Number one, there are people... For you have never made a genuine decision. You have heard that people repent. You have heard that people come to Jesus. You have even given them transport money. But genuinely from your heart. My father is a pastor. That's not what I'm saying. I grew up in a church. You are joking. You have to come genuinely. We gave our lives to Christ. It's not an inheritance of a family. You come personally. The other day they blessed all of us together. You are not born again. It has to be genuine, personal, and conscious. When I was a baby, they baptized me. Come and join them. As soon as I made that altar call, you come and join them. Are we together? Number two, there are those who, the war of passion and seriousness with God. There is this fear of getting serious with God. For some reason, you think, if I get serious with God, I won't make it in life. The moment I'm serious with God, I won't get a nice husband. Men these days don't like serious ladies. Who lied to you? Which men? Which one are you talking about? The drunk are there? The smoker are there? Or a genuine Holy Ghost born again visionary brother? If I'm serious with God, when it's time to chop in the office, my conscience will not allow me chop. That's a joke. Is it that God cannot bless you? Must you bribe to rise? That's how everybody's doing it. You are lying. That's not how every, that's how you know, or you have been taught that everybody is doing it. Elijah said, I'm the only one. God said, keep quiet. There are 7,000 others who have not bowed to Baal. Please hear me. There are people here. God wants to visit your family, but there is no one in your family who is born again. And you will be the first tonight. because God needs an access point to your family. The system of the kingdom is such that God must find a portal within a territory to manifest his purposes within that territory. If and when God does not find a man, his power is still limited. There must be an individual through sacrifice and alignment who will be able to host the purposes of the kingdom within a sphere to allow the possibilities of God find expression. So if God wants to come to your family, he moves everywhere and everybody says, I'm too busy. He comes to your mother, she says, I'm too busy looking for money. He comes to your father, I'm too confused to give my life to you. Comes to your brother, no, I'm too, I want to marry now. God, please go somewhere. He comes to your sister, I'm looking for men. There's no time to look for God. And God says, I want to step into this family. No one has given me space. If God can find one person, he needs to take it step by step. When he finds you, the prophetic implication of your relationship starts judging the powers of darkness one by one. And before you know it, someone starts having a strange dream in your family. He lies down and he has a dream of rapture. He won't share it, but that dream will torture him till he thinks about it. He will get up alone and you'll find out for the first time he didn't steal money again. He saw angels. He saw the white throne. He doesn't need to know what it is. His spirit has been designed to recognize spiritual things. But tonight, you must come genuinely to Jesus. Don't come out here if you are playing games. Let me tell you the implication of coming out here. You must be ready to scatter and destroy wrong, dangerous, and ungodly relationships by the grace and the Spirit of God. You just need the will. The grace is what you receive here. Number two, you must be ready and willing to be committed to the house of God to grow. This dilly-dallying with God is the recipe for failure. I'm too young to reject God. The fierceness of life will destroy me if at my level in life I claim I'm too big for God. Before we continue tonight, I'm going to count 1 to 10. Listen, everyone heard me loud and clear. Overflow outside, overflow along the road. As I'm speaking to you, the Holy Ghost is probing you. Those of you standing on the fence there, I see you. And the Lord is speaking to you online. Probably you are listening now or following from another nation of the world. And you are saying, but I'm far. Distance is no barrier. It doesn't matter. You are still on earth. Everyone on earth will be judged. Whether you are in London, whether you are wherever. I'm going to make this altar call now. I want you to run like there's fire on the mountain and come to Jesus. I know you will be healed, young and old. I don't care how long you have been. You are saying, Lord, I'm tired of living my life the way I want. I want to hand it genuinely. Inside, outside, start running. 1 to 10. 1. Genuinely run like there's fire on the mountain. 2.
Nina Yesu ne bazankoma bazankoma.
3.
Nasahanuna akankeke noma bazankoma.
4. Keep coming. Don't say there's no space. Even if you have to line up outside, no problem. This is your salvation with God, greater than any miracle tonight. Just find somewhere to stand. If the place is full, keep lining up here, right outside. 5. Someone is still thinking about it and saying, Apostle, I'm a nice person. I've never done anything wrong. It's just that I've not declared Jesus. Join them. By the self-righteousness of no man can he be saved. You didn't do anything wrong, but that very nature of darkness is resident upon you. All of you who are standing here, please don't look at anyone. Lift your voice in 1 minute and begin to talk to Jesus. Everyone who is standing, stretch right outside, and those online, talk to Jesus right now and say, Jesus, I come to you. I come to you. Pray, talk to him. And everyone seated, I expect you to be praying for someone's salvation. You know, everybody around you cannot be saved. There is somebody somewhere still hardened towards the things of God. Lift your voice and cry to Jesus. Lord, I'm saved, but my father is not saved. He's on his way to hellfire and I know it. My mother is not saved. I know today that if the trumpet sounds, they are going to hell for sure. I know my sister is not saved. My husband is not saved. My wife is not saved. My colleague in office is not saved. Lord, I know that pastor is not saved. He has a church but is not saved. Pray. Cry your heart to Jesus. He is here. Match miracle service. You are meeting with the Savior. He wants to reveal himself first as Savior, before deliverer, before healer. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All of you standing stretched to the outside, please look at me. I see you. Some of you are crying sincerely from your heart. Listen, there is no man who has the power and authority to condemn you, young and old. I don't care what you have done. I don't care how your life is. We are all products of his mercy and grace. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Don't let any man point an accusing finger, but then you cannot remain where you are. There are people standing here and say, man of God, if you will lead me to pray, I will love it. I've been praying for an opportunity like this, but there are powers always keeping me. Wherever you are, inside, outside, don't mind who is looking at you. Lift your right hand to heaven and you are going to say this prayer after me. Please, it is not a poem. It is a genuine prayer, meaning from the depth of your heart. It says, I am not ashamed of the gospel. Why? For it is the power of God unto salvation. The Lord wants to give you a new beginning. I know you came to be healed, but he wants to take over your destiny. With your hands lifted to Jesus, who is here, not in heaven, right here in this place, say after me, passionately and sincerely, say, Lord Jesus, I love you with all my heart. This night, I have heard your word and I make up my mind that from tonight and for the rest of my days, I will live for you. I will serve you without shame, without fear, without going back. This night, I hand over my life to you. Say it again. I hand over my life to you. Be my Lord. Be my Savior. I declare that the power of sin, of Satan, of the flesh is broken. Every association that is not of God, I am separated from them this night. I declare that the joy of salvation and the peace and a new beginning is mine from today. I am a child of God and I will live for him forever. Hallelujah. Keep your hands lifted. Jesus, look at the ones you died for. When you hung upon that cross, you saw them. And today we are glad to present them to you. This is why you put this meeting together. We lift them up as trophies, worthy trophies for your blood, worthy trophies for your death. And Lord, I decree and declare that these ones you have brought tonight, none will be lost. I speak over your life, the joy of salvation that very few people know about. May it be your inheritance today. I declare that the peace that surpasses all understanding, let it be yours today. I declare that every guilt the devil uses against you, every accusation, we roll it away right now in the name of Jesus. I declare your sins forgiven by the mercies of God. I declare that you have a new beginning with God. You are empowered by the Spirit to live a victorious life in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. Let's appreciate them. Keep standing, everyone. I'll give you some instructions now. Now, there are so many of you, probably hundreds of you. This is what I want you to do. Protocol, please help coordinate. Let's do it this way. Those of you who are in the second overflow, the overflow right from the door that leads to the road, as you go out, please let's have some of the ushers you stand so they can attend to you there. What will happen is they are going to have your details. I know you are all so many, but we want your details. We have a system to follow you up and to make sure you are grounded in God. That's number one. That's the first instruction. So those outside, those here at the overflow, and those inside, you may not need to go out. Just wait where you are and someone will come to attend to you. Please, I hope the relevant departments are listening so that we can respond to them very quickly. We have 5-10 minutes for this because I'll start praying for the sick now. Praise the Lord. Now, the second instruction I want to give all of you is this. The Bible says, they that be planted in the house of God, it says they shall flourish. It is important not only for you to just get born again, but to be planted in the house of God. Instruction number three is, we have a system of spiritual growth here in Koinonia. It's a very large house. So what we do is that anyone who gets born again, automatically we transfer them to our prayer department for 1 month. Whether or not you will continue as a member in the prayer department meets Tuesdays 4 p.m. just at the church when you walk from this road right down Rema Chapel. More information will be communicated to you. And so we usually have all new converts to be part of the prayer department. There you get to be filled with the Holy Spirit and you have seasons of prayer to build your spirit, and it helps you to cultivate a culture of the word and also to have a kingdom community that supports your spiritual growth. All these things are very important for your growth. I don't want you to waste this experience. Praise the Lord. I bless you in the name of Jesus, and shortly the Lord is going to be turning your life around in greater dimensions. So let's do this very quickly. Appreciate them as they go. Just guide them, whether or not you belong to any department, you're a member of Koinonia, you see any of them moving, just guide them as they go out. Quickly, let's honor them, Koinonia, as they do so. Is that the best you can do? Hallelujah. Please coordinate them, coordinate them. Let's just give them some room so that they can go out, and then we will shake off every power of darkness roaming around anybody's life. I never see anyone like you. I never see anyone like you. Hey, I never see anyone like you. Where's Sam? Help me.
I never see anyone like you.
I never see
anyone like you.
I never see anyone.
I never see anyone like you.
I never see.
I never see anyone like you.
I never see.
Everyone stand up. Let's pray some prayers before. Let's pray some prayers while they are walking on the people. Everyone say after me, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Please say it, be serious, in the name of Jesus. Father, tonight, visit me. Visit my destiny. Give me strange results. Lift your voice and begin to pray. Visit me in the name of Jesus. Visit me. Step into my destiny. Step into my destiny. Step into my destiny. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Shout it again, in the name of Jesus. Every long-standing issue in my life and my destiny, I declare that you must give way tonight. Lift your voice and begin to pray. Long-standing challenges. Are you praying tonight? Long standing issue. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Please, if you can, pair yourselves into two and pray this prayer. If you are holding a child or you are doing something, that's all right. Otherwise, find somebody, a serious neighbor, hold the hands. I want you to agree. Say, in the name of Jesus, I decree and declare that the door for the next level of my life and that of my neighbor must be open now. Lift your voice and pray. Agree. If any two shall agree, as touching, believe in what you are saying. You are opening doors. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You are still holding your hands. Say, in the name of Jesus. Father, tonight, take away shame. Take away mockery from my life, my family, and my neighbor. Lift your voice and pray seriously. Roll away the reproach. Roll away the reproach of mockery. Roll away the reproach of shame. Roll away the reproach. Pray. Roll away the reproach. Roll away the reproach. Hallelujah. Say, in the name of Jesus, Father, expose every force, every yoke, every spirit behind the tragedies in my life, in my destiny, and my family. Expose them tonight. Lift your voice and pray. For the light shines in darkness. for the light shines in darkness. Let your light shine, O God. Hallelujah. Say after me, in the name of Jesus. Lord, let your anointing, let your unction locate me tonight and turn my life around. Lift your voice and pray that the power of God must locate me, change my destiny. Let your power pray. One encounter with the anointing of the Holy Ghost can wipe your tears, my brother, my sister. Pray. Light me, Lord, light me, Lord, light me, Lord, like a candle. Light me, Lord, light me, Lord, light me, Lord, like a candle. Light me, Lord, light me, Lord, light me, Lord, like menorah. Light me, Lord. Listen to me. I will just give you an instruction. Just help those under the anointing, but listen to me carefully, please, everyone. Do you know the reason why we minister deliverance? Listen, listen carefully. You have to understand this. The reason why we minister deliverance, you don't spend your whole life going through deliverance. However, there are lives, come my dear, when a spirit, listen carefully, when a spirit latches onto your life and destiny, brothers and sisters, let me tell you, I don't care what you do physically. Remember spiritual intelligence. You can be doing the right physical things, but the presence of a spirit representing an embargo, representing a covenant, an authorization for your doom, will keep you down there, and you find out that your life will never open up. When people gather like this, hear me, they come with prayer requests, they come with problems, but you see, behind those problems are spirits. Are we together now? The spirits that are responsible for lack of favor, the spirits that are responsible for a hard life, the spirits that are responsible for infirmity, all kinds of cases. You know, one of our dear people here in the ministry, I prayed over the father's picture. I've seen those kinds of cases on television and all of that, but you could look at the leg and see the bone, the flesh had eaten to a point that you could see the bone. What happened to the man? He went to bed in the night, brothers and sisters, I think somebody did something for him in a dream and he woke up physically and his legs started eating up. The Bible says the whole world lieth in wickedness. You want to move forward, but there is an embargo. The solution is not counseling. You need an encounter with power. Everybody say power. Listen, the power of the Holy Spirit is not a negotiator, it's an enforcer. When the power of God comes, it does not ask you whether you want to be free. Your assignment is to be open till it reaches you. When it comes, it scatters anything that does not look like God. Lift your hands, everyone. Just lift your hands and be silent. I'll pray for you now. The Spirit of God is upon me. Lift your hands, everyone. There are people here right now. I want you to bring, there are the first sets of people who will come out. Usher's grace for you and protocol. I know you have a lot of work today because there's such a crowd right to the road. But I want to pray. Everyone, please lift your hands. The Lord is speaking to me. There are people right now in your silence. Hold on. Maybe just this. The power of God will begin to come upon you. What is happening right now before we pray for the sick is massive deliverance. That deliverance is equal to breakthrough, equal to new levels. But lift your hands. There are people here who are under strong yokes of delay. And the Lord gives me an instruction. We will just lift our hands and be silent. That's all the instruction. And inside and outside, the Spirit of God will begin to locate them. Are we together? When that happens, then we'll take it off from there. That's the first thing God wants to do tonight. Just lift your hands, everyone. Thank you, Jesus. The Lord is asking me to stretch my hands. And there are people and families and those following online. Except you are not under the influence of the spirit of delay, that spirit must leave you. Are we together? So keep your hands lifted. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, wherever they are right now, I stretch my hands. According to the instructions you have given me, inside and outside. Right now, I see the anointing of the spirit already falling over the spirit of delay. Keep your hands lifted. Shalakataya. Bring them out. Outside, there. Just the angels of the Lord are walking. I'm seeing like smoke just moving across lines, line by line, inside and outside. When it comes to you, when you are under that influence, that's the end of it. Right now, I command it. The word of the Lord is upon this prophecy. In the name of Jesus, no instruments, don't play anything. Outside, there is massive deliverance happening. Separation from delays. Separation from delays. Bring them out. Shalakatos kaprande keteyash. Kratas katepas kapratos sopredish kalabai. Thank you, Jesus. Delays. You want to move forward, but a spirit ties you down. It's over right now. No, you can't dodge it. You are under an atmosphere. There is an influence. The influence of the spirit. Line by line, the Holy Ghost is moving. Row by row, there is no faking it. Line by line, Lord, every row, every line, every individual, let no one in this category escape it. For the sake of your mercy and your grace, no matter where you are, inside and outside, online, don't worry, the Spirit of God is moving. One by one, it must catch up with you. The word of the Lord is upon it. Bring them out, young, old, destinies that have been delayed. Tonight there is serious grace for deliverance. Those of you lifting up your hands, be sensitive. Be sensitive. We're in a prophetic atmosphere right now. Bring them. I see people outside. Kai, my God, my God, my God, my God, my God, my God, my God. Many people, many people, many people, many people. There's someone you are following from Kenya. You are watching from a laptop. The anointing, your hands are shaking. The Spirit of the Lord is upon you. Judging every darkness. Kalabakatayabada. Tonight you will be located by God. You prayed it. You must be free. Please help the ushers. If there are too few, protocol, join them. Different departments, help them. The Lord really wants to set people free. It's a year of triumph. Don't think these people are just coming out for show. They represent breakthroughs. These are the people who God wants to give testimonies. Darkness raging over the lives of people. They came from different places. How will God leave them that way? Right now, all of you in front here, I decree and declare to those spirits, at the count of three, let them go. You know my voice. 1, 2, 3, go. Go, go, go. Out of their lives now. Out now. I command you, by the influence of the Spirit, I decree and declare, let their destinies go. Delay, broken. Go now. Hallelujah. Now lift your hands. My God, you'll be surprised at what will happen now. Everyone say after me, in the name of Jesus. Say it again, in the name of Jesus. Say it again, in the name of Jesus. The grace for open doors right now. Break every chain in my life. Keep your hands lifted. Watch it happen now. That's the instruction God gave me. That grace, breaking chains now. I'm speaking across the congregation. I've been seeing this for weeks. Padlocks opening in the realm of the spirit. That's what the Lord is showing me. Padlocks opening, opening, opening right now. I open them.
I'm under the shadow of yours. Your influence is all over me. I'm under the shadow of yours. Your influence is all over me. I'm under the shadow. Your influence is all over me.
Fire is coming on 32 people, and this fire that is coming upon them is to break family altars. I hear family altars right now, oh God, in the name of Jesus. 1, 2, 3, I set those altars now on fire right now. 32 people I see in the realm of the spirit. I command it right now. I command it. Everyone on this ground, under the influence of any altar, now be free now. Help them, please. Help that lady. Be free now. Right now, be free now. Be free now.
Your influence is all over me. I'm under the shadow of your wings.
Everyone lift your hands. Say this after me, in the name of Jesus. Please say it seriously. Say, in the name of Jesus, any spirit that has had access to my life
and is causing destruction, hear the word of the Lord. As I shout the name Jesus, I command you to live my life. At the count of three, shout Jesus. There will be an exiting of many strange spirits. 1, 2, 3, shout it. I command spirits, you go now. You go now. You go now. You go now. Inside and outside. Any spirit resident within any man's life, any woman's life, causing pain.
Help me sing.
Hallelujah. Ushers, I pray for grace for you in Jesus' name. Because what I see now is not a nice thing. The Lord is asking me that we shout Jesus. There are people who are going to vomit physical things. That's why I said it's a messy sin. I apologize. We're very neat and organized people inside and outside. But in the name of Jesus right now, any stranger in your body at the count of three must go out now. 1, 2, 3. I command every stranger, go now. Every poison, every devil causing sicknesses, every fibroid, every devil, every enchantment. Hallelujah. The Lord is showing me a vision of a lady. If you're here, I want you to come out. I'm seeing your family doing something like a sacrifice, and they are giving somebody, everybody, a substance like a drink, something to take. They gave everybody, including you, and you took it. Where is that person? Please, if you're here, I want you to come out quickly. It's a highly diabolic thing they gave everybody. Where are you? Come. Your deliverance comes now.
I'm under the shadow of your wings.
Help me.
Your influence is all over me.
Let's have another mic, please. Hold on. Stand up, my dear. Is this the lady? Two of them? Stand up. Where are you from? Look at me.
Huh?
Kogi State. What happened to you? Hold on.
I converted.
Hold on. I'm looking at you, Kai. This thing. You entered a covenant. Huh?
Yes.
With who?
I don't know. My mother. I don't know.
They brought somebody and you people entered a covenant. And they gave you something. Hold my hands. Shout Jesus. I command that covenant, that demonic thing tying your life in this miracle service, it leaves now in the name of Jesus. You too? Where are you from?
I'm from Kogi State.
You are from Kogi State. The same thing. Hold my hands. Look at me. I command that devil to leave you now. Whatever yoke, please don't come out if I don't call your case. Are you part of them, Mr. Man? Young man, you're part of them. In the name of Jesus, I set you free. Bring you too. Come, make sure that so that we don't get the place rowdy, be delivered now. Help her out, be free now. Out. I'm interested in this lady. Please stand up, my dear, if you can. This lady's whole family is in bondage. Whole family, the entire family, nothing is working in your family. The Lord wants to deliver you right now. Hold my hands. I command that spirit, your time is up. Leave this family now. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. I break the yoke over your life now. Out! Now!
There is a lady. You have been coughing blood. Where are you? You are coughing literally and blood is coming out. There is a lady like that. Please, where are you? Let's hurry up. We have a lot to do this night. The Lord is asking me to minister to a lady that coughs and then blood. You cough blood. Who is that? Inside, outside, except you are under the anointing. Please come out quickly. I want to pray for that person now. Where are you? How long? Hold on. Just keep her. Where's the mic? How long? You are an usher? You? How long?
3 weeks.
Eh?
3 weeks.
For 3 weeks you've been caught. Lay your hand on your chest. You too? Lay your hands on your chest. You too? Huh?
Substance.
Your what? Hold on, please. Guys, hold on. Yours is what?
The substance you spoke about.
What substance?
Family.
Lift your hands. Lift your hands. Lift both of them. I'm seeing an angel pouring something on your hand. Your hand will start shaking. And then the Lord is bringing you strange deliverance. It will start from your hands down to your body. I place the word of God upon your life right now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Both of you, look at me. Both of you, cough out blood. In the name of Jesus, I lay my hands upon you. It ends now. In the name of Jesus, out right now. There are spirits responsible for this. You know what I just saw? The Lord opened my eyes and I saw like a cage, and in the cage I saw snakes. That's all I'm seeing. Lift your hands, everybody. The Lord is just asking me to wave my hands over the congregation. There are people who represent that oppression. It will leave now. The Lord is asking me to wave my hands. Lord, as you have said, I see snakes in cages. Whose destiny is that? Right now, whose destiny is that? I wave my hands in the name of Jesus. Please release them for your glory. Release them now. Help them, please, Jesus Christ. Inside, outside, be out of that cage now. I see snakes, serpents. Some of you see them in your dreams. They must go now. They are leaving you now. Now. They are leaving you now. I command liberty. 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 Hallelujah. I'm hearing a name, Jane. Jane, like J-A-N-E. Jane. I'm also hearing another name, Victory. Is it Victory? Like Victory. Victory. Please don't come out if that's not your name. What's your name? Jane. Your name is Victory. Where are you from?
Delta State.
Delta State. I have to pray for you. Your family has been seriously oppressed. Why are you people here? You are all Jane. Jane, your name is Victory. I want to pray for you. Kazachat. Is it Kazachat? Who is that? Kazachat. I'm hearing that name. That's like a Kaduna name. Kazachat. Please, who is that? The breakthrough of your family has come. Kazachat. Is it, I don't know why God is going to Kaduna now. Nomshu or Nomshu or something like that. I don't know if there's a name like that. Nomshu or something like that. Nom something. Please, if that is your name, why are they here? I call their names. I'm going to lay hands on you. Except for you, I don't even know why the rest of you are. But please, I want you to believe. The moment I lay my hands on you, something will happen. The Lord is saying I should start with you. Lord, open her door now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hold my hands. Reproach leaves your life now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Reproach leaves your life now. By the power of the Holy Ghost. Reproach leaves your life now. Reproach leaves your life now. Hold my hands. Call your parents and tell them the Lord is giving them breakthrough. Your family, your entire family. Delta State, breakthrough right now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hold on. There's serious witchcraft over your life. Hold my hands. Lord, the Lord is asking me to walk with you. This is how your destiny is opening up. That's what the Lord is asking me to do. Walk with you. To walk with you. Something is happening. It's a prophetic act. You will not help her to walk with you. Opens in the name of Jesus. Your destiny opens up now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Lift your hands. This girl, lift your hands where you are. I'm seeing wind around you. And the Lord is, that wind is going anti-clockwise. Anti-clockwise. And the Lord said it's restoration. I stretch my hands upon you right now. I release that grace for restoration. Restoration. There are seven other people who will tap from this anointing. This same anointing right now. Seven right now. The anointing for restoration is coming upon them. Receive it right now wherever you are. Zabata kata lakata frate kese brende gatai. Lekate praskata barato shubre diara. Hallelujah. I'm seeing one mama outside. It's like you came here with your daughter or something. I'm seeing a woman sit down with her daughter outside. Now that's all I'm giving about you. Please, if you can find that woman and if you understand what I've said, I want you to run and come. I want to pray for the sick now, but God is delivering people. God is delivering people. Seth, who is Seth? S-E-T-H. S-E-T-H. Your name is Seth. Seth, the Lord is stepping into his life right now. Seth, is there someone with that name? Seth. Have you found the mama I'm talking about? Don't worry, let them come. Let them come. Doesn't matter. With your daughter. Mama. Kai. There is the spirit of death on your family. I'm going to pray for you. Don't be afraid. I'm not a prophet of doom. You came from where, Mama?
I came from Edo State.
From Edo State.
You live in Wusasa,
yes. But you came from Edo State. Yes. I must pray for you. Why is he here? Who is this gentleman? Seth. You too. You are an usher. Okay. This is not the Seth I'm seeing. No, I will pray for you, but I'm seeing someone else. Eh? Please don't be embarrassed. I want to pray for somebody now. Huh? Because I'm seeing an accident killing you, and you took, what's the name of this thing they take? Wee-wee. And you were high. You were about to cross the road, and then I'm seeing a truck with the name Dangote on it, just running and killing you. There is somebody here, you smoke. Please don't be, there's nothing to be embarrassed about. It's not like you are not a serious person, but this thing, you started taking it from when you were small. And it's destroying your life. You want to be free, but you can't leave it. Please don't be ashamed. Come out now. Quickly, please. If you are still thinking about it, remain on your seat. You have to be free now. Come out. I'm seeing one, you wore jeans dress, like your shirt. I don't know if it's your shirt, it's jeans. Who is that? No. There's another. Come out. I will pray for you. This is not the only guy. Just keep them here. I will pray for him. I'm seeing another person outside the second overflow. You are standing on the road. The Spirit of God is speaking to you. Speaking to you. This thing they roll and they smoke. And then I'm seeing you swallowing a drug. I don't know what drug is that. Please come out. Come out. Clap for them as they come out. Join them quickly and come. whether I mention your case or not, you are involved in any kind of liquor and addiction, Indian hemp, whatever, forward march. Come here, your salvation, come, sir. Please appreciate them, clap for them. Some of them are not bad people, it's a spirit. Don't be ashamed. Please, usher, direct them so that they come here. I'm seeing up to five ladies in this group. Up to five ladies, come. Don't be ashamed, don't let anyone laugh at you. Please, this is a miracle service. Join them, wee-wee, codeine, whatever it is, join them. Whether you know the name of what you are smoking or swallowing or not, come and join them. Please, quickly, that addiction must be broken now. Who can stand against the Lord?
No one can. No one will.
Keep coming, the devil is a liar.
Who can stand against our King? No one can. No one will.
Oh, oh,
oh, oh, oh, oh. Victory belongs to Jesus.
Victory belongs to Him.
Victory belongs to Him.
Hallelujah. I'm seeing a very small boy. Very small boy, very small boy. Who is supposed to join them? Young man, please hold on. Please, if the parents of the boy are here, don't flog him. Please, this is a very small boy. You will not even know that this boy is wise to smoke this thing. He saw an elderly person smoking it. Come out. There is a small boy here. I know what. Drag him out. Come. Where is the boy? Come out, please. Gentlemen, I'm going to pray for you. Don't worry, you are not bad people. I'm seeing a number of ladies, up to five ladies. They are refusing to come out. There's nothing to be embarrassed. Jesus Christ wants to set you free. This is a miracle service. It's not like you are evil people. That's not what we are saying. It's a spirit. You don't stop by counseling. Mama, there is a spirit of death over your family, and I will pray for you. I will pray for you in the name of Jesus. Who is this? Your daughter. What's your name, my dear?
Lillian.
Hold on. Is this mic working? Can you add
Lillian,
the voice?
Lillian.
Lillian. What do you want God to do for you?
I want God to heal you.
What's wrong with you?
I've been having problems with my tongue.
No. 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 You had a dream. Huh? You saw a snake. You can't even remember it. And from that day, you started having serious problem with your stomach. Huh? What's wrong with you?
I've got a test, and they told me that it's a liver problem.
Liver problem.
Yes,
because I look at you and you would think you are pregnant, but you are not pregnant. Your stomach is swelling up. Mama, is that true?
Yes.
How long has it been?
It's up to 3 years now.
Look at evil and wickedness. Are you married? Because you see now, assuming a brother has been trusting God to marry this sister, do you think the brother will marry her? Please help me. Do you think he will marry her? You look at her now and you think she's 5 or 6 months pregnant, but she's not pregnant. Kai. There is a lady who has refused to come out. The power of God is going to come upon her outside. You are supposed to be part of those who will be delivered here. I'm seeing the angel of the Lord outside. That lady, you were a sincere lady, but I don't know if it's another lady. I don't want to say what I'm seeing, not to embarrass you, because what you were introduced to is not only smoking this. There are other things that I see that I may not be able to talk about. I'm asking you to come out. God wants you to be free for the sake of your family. The power of God is going to come upon you outside. Outside. To be free of this thing. My dear, look at me. This is Koinonia. The Lord is going to set you free. You believe in miracles? Mama, you believe in miracles?
Yes,
I have to pray for you. Money runs away from you. Huh? Madam, I will pray for you. Mama? Yamuke. Do you hear Hausa?
Yeah.
Okay, this is your daughter.
Yes.
Please be comfortable. Whatever language you can speak, there is an interpreter here. Nobody says you must be able to speak English or whatever. Any language, please. If I call you here or you stand here for healing, don't be under any pressure to say you must. Whatever language is comfortable, speak it. If I don't understand, we'll find somebody to interpret. Please, don't put yourself under pressure and say, no, we are excellent people, but we are not fools. We can't put anyone under pressure. Hallelujah. Mommy, I want to pray for you because I'm seeing the Lord bringing restoration to your life. This is what I am seeing. And the Lord is asking me to pray for you. Can I pray for you, ma'am? I will pray for you. I have to pray. I'm seeing not you, but I'm seeing somebody close to you having an accident, traveling to Abuja and having an accident. We have to pray. I'm not saying it will happen. Once God reveals it is broken. Lord Jesus, stretch your hands and let's pray for this mommy. You don't have to know her. Please stretch your hands and pray. Lord, we avert death. We avert death now. In the name of Jesus Christ, we avert death by the power of the Holy Ghost. Mama, is there a name like Griselda? Is it Griselda or Griselda? Griselda or Griselda, something like that. Griselda, Griselda, something like that. If that sounds like your name, I'm sorry if I don't mention it well. The Lord kept mentioning it in my ears. Griselda or Griselda, something like that. If that is your name, please come out. Eh? Jacinta? No. But come, where are you coming from?
Zaria.
Zaria, I have to pray for you. There's a gentleman who will destroy you. Be free now from every influence. Hold my hand. Anybody that is not designed by God, I separate you and him forever. Say amen. In Jesus' name. Griselda. Griselda. I'm hearing Griselda. Something Hilda. Please. If it's not you, no problem. But that's what I'm hearing. Mama, let's pray. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray for you by the power of the Holy Spirit. New beginning for you. Hold up, please. In the name of Jesus Christ. My dear, lay your hands on your stomach. Kai. Lord Jesus, you gathered people here tonight to set them free. I curse the spirit responsible for this. I decree and declare that this stomach will shrink, every devil will go away in the name of Jesus Christ. If you agree with me, say amen.
Amen.
Look at me, and you will never be barren in your life. Say amen. There are two ladies, you are inside here. There is an embargo of barrenness on your family. Fire is coming on those two ladies now to break that embargo. You don't even know. It's in your family, it may not be in your life, but I'm seeing it right now. The angel of the Lord is locating two ladies right now and is breaking that embargo. Thank you, Father. I put the word of God upon this prophetic word. That embargo is broken right now. Right now, right now, two ladies, there's no reason why you should come here and your life should be the same. Mama, I will pray for you. This is your daughter. Do you know that God is going to use this girl? God will use your daughter for his glory. Hold my hands, my dear. There is a small girl now, but God will use you in the name of Jesus Christ. I anoint you. Mama, I decree and declare, let hardship leave your life. In the name of Jesus Christ, let hardship leave your life. In the name of Jesus. Hold on. I'm seeing a wind and the Lord is asking me to follow it. This is somebody's deliverance here. This is somebody's deliverance here. This is somebody's deliverance here. This is somebody's deliverance. The power of God is coming upon a few people as I'm walking across this place. This is somebody's deliverance. This is somebody's deliverance. Lord, set them free right now. Right now. Right now. I'm seeing something rolling around this row. This row. This row. This row. Shalasobaria taska bandabria. Legetegeba sharatos kabridia. There's no hiding. There's no hiding. Someone in this row. Someone in this row. Someone in this row. Hardship over your family is being broken right now. I'm stretching my hands. This row. Right there. Father, locate that person right now. Right now. Right now. Right now. Right now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Mama, come. I want you to rejoice. Look at me. The Lord, hold on. The Lord is saying, I should tell you that where you have been crying, you will begin to laugh. You have been crying for 30 years, and the Lord is saying your breakthrough has come. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Please shake for me. Come, madam. Hold my hands. The Lord is there and should tell you it's your season of laughter. In the name of Jesus Christ. Your season of laughter. Your season of laughter. Look at me. Lose her hands now. Lose her hands now. Lose her hands now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Let her hands be loose. Your hands are tied. I lose your hands in the realm of the spirit. In the name of Jesus Christ. Open doors, open doors, open doors, open doors, open doors. That's what the Lord is saying. Open doors. The Lord has said, you have waited too long. It's time for the door of your destiny to be open. Open doors. Come. There is a spirit in your life that makes bad boys look for you. Hold my hands. Leave her now. Out. Out. When bad boys see you, they can't leave you. As they are passing, they see you, that spirit calls them back. I don't know who this girl is. You are a small girl, but the things you know and what you have done. Out now. In the name of Jesus. You have gone to places you should not go. You have the phone numbers of people that if we know now, I'm not saying you're a bad girl. It's a spirit, including married men. They will be minding their business. That spirit will call them to you. I command that devil to leave you now. Leave you now in the name of Jesus Christ. I want us to pray for these gentlemen before we pray for the sick. You see, let me tell you something. Addiction is a very wicked spirit. Don't look at them, especially our dear sisters. My brother, what happened to you?
Gunshot.
Gunshot.
Yes, sir.
Who shot you?
I'm a soldier. I was shot by my colleague, Meduguri.
You are Meduguri?
Yes, sir.
No. He wanted to kill you, but he didn't kill you. He was directed to kill you. Hi. You are a soldier. How long has this been?
It's going to 7 months now.
7 months. Where did they shoot? Your legs. And you can't walk with it. Look at me. You believe in miracles? Lift your crutch. Lift it. Lift it. Come. Come. Lift your legs. Go ahead. You are a soldier. Lift your legs. Look at this. Come on, Koinonia. Look at this. Lift your crotch up. Look at this. Look at this. Look at this. Walk as fast as you can. Don't be afraid. Turn around. Turn around. Come. Because your wound is not healing. There is a wound, but there is not healing. From today, I pray for you in the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord who has perfected this leg will also perfect you. Where are you now? You are in Zaria. You are still in the force.
Yes.
You are still in the force.
Yes, sir.
I want to pray for you. Do you believe God can favor you?
Yes, sir.
I have to pray for you. God is going to connect you with a senior person and he will lift you. Look at me, brothers and sisters. I want to break this addiction from your life now. Are we together? You are very sincere people. Some of you were initiated into this thing by bad friends. Some of you were initiated into these things by spirit. I'm going to lay my hands on you while the congregation, whether your child is here or not, whether your brother is here or not, as you are praying, you are sowing a seed for your own home. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Stretch your hand. Don't look at anybody's face and run your mouth on anybody. It's none of your business. Koinonia is like a hospital. Stretch your hands. I will lay my hands on every one of them. Please, all of you should pray. I want to break addiction from your life. Don't feel condemned. Jesus will help you. It must be broken right now. Broken right now. Broken right now. Any kind of addiction. Out. Out. Now. Out. Out. In the name of Jesus. Out. Look at this guy. Out. Break from his life now. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, be set free. Be set free. As soon as I lay my hands on you, continue praying. Be set free. Addiction, break. Break in the name of Jesus. Hold my hands, darling. No addiction for liquor. No addiction for drugs. Something is leaving you. I'm seeing something like an arrow coming out of your head. Out of her life now. In the name of Jesus, I break that addiction. Ah. Hey Jimmy, come. The Lord is saying you should pray for this guy. He will pray for you. This guy needs serious prayer. Just lay your hands on him. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus. Out! Out! Now! I command that devil. This is somebody that loves God, but this addiction must be broken right now. I break it right now. I break it right now. Hold my hand. You're a nice lady, but we have to break this thing. Lord, please, for your mercy, let it be broken in her life. In the name of Jesus Christ. 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 Hallelujah. The Lord is asking me to minister to somebody. I'm seeing a very interesting case. You love God. Please don't be ashamed. There is a particular pain reliever you are addicted to. Who is that person? I want to pray for you now. Whether you are sick or not, come and stand here. Particular pain reliever. You can't help it. You can wake up 1 a.m. in the night and swallow it. It's a spirit. Pain reliever. I'm not saying you are sick and they gave you in the hospital. God is visiting addictions this night. Quickly, come. Don't sit back and say, I'm all right. Allow God set you free. Let them come. Look at this. Pain. I don't know what it is, but I hear my spirit, pain reliever. Whether you are sick, whether you are fine, the urge will hook you and you have to go and get it. If you can prefer to take it than to eat food, it must go right now.
You reign, you reign. Elohim, you reign, you reign. Elohim, you reign, you reign. Elohim, you reign. Yeah, na 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 na.
Let's talk about deliverance now. The number of things I want to teach you about deliverance. Let's talk about demons. Let's talk a little bit. I have to, if I don't talk about demons, I'm looking at my course content here. Can we talk a little about demons? Matthew chapter 13, verse 24 to 30. Let's go to the parable of Jesus. I want us to study a bit on demons. Look at this. Another parable, look up please. He put forth unto them, saying, the kingdom of heaven, that means the operation of the kingdom of heaven, is likened to this: a man which sowed good seed. Everybody say a man. Everybody say seed. One more time, say a man. Say seed. He sowed good seed. The fact that the Bible specified good seed already is a message. Are we together? Remember my message during the prayer and fasting? 25. But while men slept, while men did what? His enemy came also having a seed. His enemy didn't come with a knife. His enemy didn't come with a gun. His enemy watched what he sowed and came with his own too. Watch this. And the Bible says he came and sowed tares among the wheat and did what? And went his way. He represented his presence with the seed. Are we together now? He went away. When he dropped that seed there, he didn't need to stay there again, because he knew that the seed was a replica of himself. But when the blade was sprung up, so that which was a seed now became something else and brought forth fruit, then appeared tares also. So the servants of the household that came and said unto him, sir, did not thou sow good seed in thy field? In other words, didn't you get born again? Where did this come from? Are you not a pastor's child? Are you not a prophet's daughter? Are you not? Is it not you that was baptized yesterday? Where did this come from? From whence then hath it tears? 28. And he said, an enemy has done this. And then his servant told him, will thou that we gather them up? And then he says, allow it. That's what 29 and 30 says. Lest while we gather up the tears, we root up the wheat in them. And then verse 30, let them both grow together until harvest. In the time of the harvest, I will say to the reapers, gather first the tears. That means something will happen in the time of harvest that will show the difference. But as it is now, you can't see it. And if in an attempt, watch this. If you understand this mystery, you will know why you can be doing many things and God will not talk to you about it. It doesn't mean that he doesn't see it. It's because if he wants to circumcise you at that level, it will affect your growth process so bad, so he will be patient with you to just grow. You can be an arrogant man and God will never say anything about your arrogance. So you will think that you are all right just because he's not talking about it. A day will come as you keep walking with him, when he sees that you are now mature to undergo that level of spiritual circumcision, he will take you back to the subject of arrogance. And you will be surprised that you are in that level of height and now God is dealing with the issue of arrogance. The seed. This demon spirits that we're talking about, we have to understand them. You hear people say demons everywhere. Many of you here in Koinonia and around, you've seen demons come out of people. You've seen their violence. You've seen their aggression. Sometimes you hear people speak, you know, another spirit. Many of you watch TV around or go for meetings where you, who are they? Where do they come from? Genesis chapter 3. Let's see how we can look at it. Oh, Jesus. Is God blessing us already? Genesis chapter 3. Give us verse 15. Genesis chapter 3. Let me just touch on it, and that God will grant us grace. Now, by way of introduction to this, I hope you know that Paul the Apostle did not leave us in the dark as to the fact that when the Bible says darkness, it's a combination of many things. I hope you know that. When the Bible says darkness and it says spirit, dark spirit, it's not just one, a consummation of just a group of demons. It is the summation of every spirit entity and every kind of spiritual organogram that is antagonistic to the ways of God. Because as I'll be showing you, there are many. There are many. This is the Lord now speaking with the woman after their fall. I'm just saving time. That's why I said we should go to verse 15. If you're with me, say amen. And I will put enmity. Who is speaking here? God. Between thee and the woman. Between Satan and the woman. God is speaking to them both now. I will put enmity between you, Satan, and the woman. He would have stopped there and then we'll understand. But then he says, I will also put enmity between what? Thy seed and her seed. So the person he's talking to, her seed. Are you getting what I'm saying now? He's talking to Satan as one who has seed, the capacity to multiply himself and his agenda. Hi. And he looks at the woman. You don't talk to a woman about seed, because you know from biology that women don't have seed. They receive seed. So the thing confused Satan. God, why are you now talking about her seed? Where is it going to come from? That's why the moment Cain came, Satan believed that Cain was that seed and tried to attack him. From that day till Moses, till everybody, till John the Baptist, once Satan sees a male that a woman is giving birth to, he starts pursuing them because he suspects that that may be the seed. Are you getting the point now? Between your seed and her seed. Now, questions. We have seen the seed of the woman. We are part of that seed, correct? Where is the seed of Satan? Because the Bible lets us know very clearly, God himself speaking, that as the woman is multiplying her own seed, this spirit entity is multiplying his own seed too. Are we together? Genesis chapter 6. Genesis chapter 6. And it came to pass, I'm fast forwarding now. It came to pass when men began to multiply upon the surface of the earth. Listen carefully. It says, and daughters were born unto them. What happened? Verse 2. That the sons of God, the Hebrew word there is benign Elohim. It's not just sons of God like, it was an error in translation. It's not like sons of God like believers. No. Are we together? Like progenitors, those who were part of his creation. These were a class of angels. That this class of angels came and saw the daughters of men. Do you know who these angels were? These angels were not just the exalted angels, because I hope you know that by the time the angels that fought with Lucifer fell from heaven, the ones that came down with him, Adam was not there. Adam's story and Genesis 1 was not there. They had fallen in a particular dispensation. Are you getting what I'm saying now? So by the time God is creating Adam, or recreating the earth and making Adam, there are already inhabitants in the earth. Satan alongside the myriads of fallen angels. Are you getting what I'm saying now? And because spirits don't die in the context of cessation of life. I will tell you what the death of a spirit is. I told you I was going to tell you. But spirits don't die in the context of ceasing from breathing and ceasing from movement. The moment Adam came to start another race, these spirits were looking for a way to find expression. Are we together now? It's a very serious thing. And the Bible says that while they were voyaging around the earth, all of a sudden they saw the daughters of men that they were fair to look upon. It's a scriptural way of saying they were very beautiful. Are we together? That means those angels had feelings. Hello? It's not all the classes of angels that, you know, theologically there are all kinds of arguments whether angels have the ability to reproduce or not. And we see it here that the angels saw the daughter of men, the daughters of men, and they took them wives. That means they could marry. They came down and saw beautiful ladies like you looking at me now, and the angels chose, they advised themselves. He said, look, let's marry these women. Verse 3. And the Lord said, my spirit shall not always strive with man, for seeing that his flesh is dead shall be 120. Verse 4. There were what? Now watch this. The Bible just tells us that an angel, are we together now? A fallen angel, Benign Elohim, all of a sudden sees human people, pure humans, and the Bible says took them to wives. And all of a sudden we now see the manifestation of a species that the Bible calls them what? I'm trying to trace the origin of demons for you. That giants, until this time, there were no demons on earth. There were fallen angels. There were other dark spirits that had been in other civilizations, but not demons. These giants were in the earth. The Bible says that when the sons of God came into the daughters of men, you know what that means? And they bear what? Children. That means that the seed, those fallen angels had seed within them, and that their seeds got these women pregnant, and they gave birth to these giants who were mighty men of old, men of renown. Are you following my story now? So we traced that these women were minding their business. All of a sudden these beings come, that there is a possibility. Ah, goodness. So spirits can get physical women pregnant. So we see that there's no argument there. Are we together? This information is useful. We need it, because that's how Jesus came into the world. Are we together now? Listen carefully. Jesus came into the world. How shall these things be, seeing that I know not a man? Joseph has not finished paying my dowry. Don't embarrass me. And he said, no, a spirit is coming from heaven. I will show you. This is the mystery. Ah, goodness. I'm already excited. Let me just take it easy. So these spirits came, and all of a sudden, when the women gave birth to children, the children started growing unusually. They had features that were superhuman. It was clear that these spirits were not pure humans. The seed of Lucifer in those children started causing them. The Bible says God saw that the wickedness of man, this spirit started introducing attributes upon the earth. Men were not that wicked. All of a sudden there was a fabrication of different levels of wickedness, and then the people in the earth, who are these beings that can be so wicked? That means a normal man has a maximum level to which his heart can conceive evil. If evil goes beyond that level, something else is responsible for that level of heartlessness. Follow me. Because as I taught you, this seed is still on earth today. Are we together? The Bible says that every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was evil continually. This was not the case. Now man had become so depraved. The Bible says, and it repented the Lord that he had made the man in earth, and it grieved his heart. Now watch this. Thank you, darling. Did you know the Lord said, I will destroy man whom I have created from the face of the earth, both man and beast and the creeping thing and the fowls of the air, for it repented me that I have made them. Just stop there. God is regretting. These spirits have found their way back into this Adamic civilization. They were there, casted.
now with the ability to reproduce, they found a way of creating continuity for themselves. Because remember the law of territory, if you don't have a body, these angels, these spirits, because they are not demons, it is demons that don't have bodies. Angels have bodies. That's why they could come to even meet. Angels can translate themselves into physical bodies. Is that true? Remember the angels that came to Abraham? They didn't come as ghosts flying. They were human beings. This was what caused the flood of Noah. Are you getting what I'm saying now? The flood of Noah was a system of judgment that God needed to annihilate that entire race. The question is, the giants, let me use you again, the giant children that were born by these angels and this, when the flood happened, because spirits don't die in terms of cessation of living, the bodies now died and the spirits. Are you getting the point now? The spirits of all those race, the name of those giants, as you know, theologically speaking, is called the Nephilims. Are we together now? These disembodied spirits, because every time a spirit is not in a body, what happens? It becomes restless. These spirits, they can't go to heaven, they can't go to hell, and they float within the circumference of earth and the second heavens. And that is the reason why these spirits today are those we call demons. Listen carefully. The demon spirits that you call are the spirits of these Nephilims, the sons. Before demons came, there was already darkness. Listen carefully. Before demons came, there were already fallen angels. The fallen angels and the daughters of men produce what we call demons, disembodied spirits. Now watch this. Look up. I want to prove a few things for you. I hope that you are getting what. Are we still together? Let me just know that we're together. Do you know that fallen angels cannot possess men? There is no record in scripture from Genesis to Revelation where a spirit was inside a man. Are we together now? And then they ask, who are you? And he says, I'm angel so 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 and so. No, it may look like it is the spirit, but those, I will tell you what their office is, because those fallen angels are still walking today, but they are not the ones inside men. Are we together? Those disembodied spirits are the ones who move. And I hope you know that the disembodied spirits that fell are by far more than the number of human beings on earth. That's why 10,000 of them will not mind finding accommodation in one man. There is a desperate need for accommodation among those demon spirits till today. Look at how they cry when you want to cast them out. That means they don't. Listen, are you seeing the extreme violence? Now, please don't feel bad. Many of you have been delivered. Many of you will be delivered this night. But listen, notice that you will see a kind, quiet person, brother or sister, and all of a sudden, when those spirits are provoked by the power of God, it will take five people to suddenly hold one person. You see the way people are rolling on the floor. There is no power. You try rolling like that by yourself and see what happens. Another entity, these disembodied spirits, to the point that when Jesus was about to cast them, they begged him. They said, Jesus, you know our condition. You are not in ignorance as to what is happening to us. Because they know it's hard to find a body that can allow you to be comfortable. That's why when they find it, they go straight to the realm of your mind and create a system that makes sure even if they evict them, they can still come back. Please understand what I'm teaching you, and you will be free. You will experience victory and you will possess your possession. Demon spirits, they are everywhere today. As I'm talking now, there are demon spirits around, hoping and waiting. Where will I get accommodation now? Are we together now? Where will I get accommodation now? This is what it means for spirits to die. When they say a demon spirit should die, is the restlessness that is created by exiting it from a mortal body. It is an intense state of torture. No spirit is like putting you inside water and dropping you there. That's exactly what you do. When that's why they cry and they beg, they make sure they don't leave, they negotiate all kinds of things. Jesus, have you come to cast us? Shall we have a time now? Jesus said, go. Say, let's look at, they drowned the swine. They were so desperate for bodies, they entered pigs for a few minutes just so that they can find a place to rest. The pigs were entering water. They said, yes, let's just be rested before you enter the water. You see why Satan hates deliverance? You may not know what it is. That is the reason why when you cast out devils, you are in trouble, because Satan will mobilize any kind of attack on your life, attack on anything. He knows what is happening. Is God helping us? Are we understanding something? So this spirit, but there are other kinds of spirits. I hope you know that the fallen angels that fell with Lucifer are not the only angels that have fallen. There are many group of offenses. There are others who fell so bad, they are in chains now. They are not even allowed to be featured in. That's the level of wickedness. Those guys are more wicked than Satan himself. What they did to God, we'll find out when we get to heaven. That God, they were cast down, not to the earth. Satan was cast down and left in the earth. But these spirits were taken straight to the bottomless pit and were bound there with chains. Because for the sake of the elect, they were not left on earth. What would they have done? That means even Satan would have been afraid of them. I'm demystifying this thing to you. Whether it comes as occultism, whether it comes as Ogboni, there is a central system of operation. It's when it comes to execution that all those variations come. The foundation of all of this is this spirit finding a resting place. And when this these angels watch their children called demons move around with no bodies in intense torture, and so they say, let's work together. We will coordinate you while you enter the people, will tell you what to do. And so Paul said, wow, so there are principalities, there are powers, there are rulers, then there are others who don't operate in the earth realm. They are spiritual wickedness in the heavenly places. They all coordinate themselves. One demon spoke on behalf of 10,000 of them. It was when Jesus asked him, who are you? He now said, we are many. Oh, forget that you are hearing only my voice. There is an intelligent organogram. Brothers and sisters, if one human body can host 10,000 demons, then it's important for you to listen. One demon, one body can be so powerful. If one body can host God, why can't it host demons? That a man's body can be the temple of the living God. Let me just compose myself and get somewhere. Because if you don't understand this, what are you delivering? You see where we miss it? We just come and tell somebody there's a spirit. Oh yeah, we bend his head and just turn him around. Oh yeah, you must come out. Sorry, yeah, I'll hug you after I'm done with my example. And you turn his head round, and the guy just says, man, let me just quietly fall for this guy to leave me in peace. And he just falls down, and you tell him to say thank you Jesus. He repeats after you. You get up and you are happy. And the demon spirit say, wow, what ignorance. Advantage. Demon spirits can dwell in your spirit. Demon spirits can dwell in your mind. Demon spirits can dwell in your body. When you tell somebody you cast a demon, it just comes out. You don't know where it came out from. It will the same way it comes out from your spirit, your soul, and your body, physically it will look the same. It takes discernment to know what happened and the authority of scripture that guides you. If that person you are delivering is a believer, then you know certainly it must not be from his spirit, because he that is joined to Christ is one spirit. Are we together? But that does not mean, this is where many of us have been surprised, because for many years you believe that no, these demons cannot find expression. You came for koinonia, and to your surprise, praise and worship was going on, and all of a sudden you are feeling as if somebody is drawing your clothes. You are saying, what is happening? The next thing, you are sweeping the ground. You are waking up after 10 minutes. What is wrong? And you are a pastor, and you are a prayer leader, and your members were watching. I say, God, prayer leader, what? I hope that this we received impartation the night before this deliverance. So what really entered us? No, you don't stigmatize people. It's spiritual childishness to think just because a demon was casted out, that no, you don't do that. The fact that you are being delivered is a sign that you are in Mount Zion. It's not something that should make you ashamed. That means you have gotten to a place where the light and the power of God is forcing those spirits to be uncomfortable. It's a thing of joy. You have to understand these demon spirits, because they are everywhere. There are many ways they can enter. That's why they are desperate. You can know that these spirits are, let me tell you this, those spirits have on you their characteristics. You know that they are in or around your life, because whatever they produce in your life is abnormal. Are we together? A demon spirit can find expression, and you can start having abnormal passion for food. You can eat the food of 10 people. It's called gluttony. It's not a medical condition. The spirit is eating through you. Even you know that by myself, I cannot eat this kind of food. Listen. This spirit now enters you and begins to manifest an unusual passion. Then you marry one wife. The spirit is not satisfied with one woman. You now say, oh, let me just be careful. This is my one and only wife. The spirit says, no way. And all of a sudden, you add 12 more. And the spirit still says, more. You add 12 more. And the spirit says, you are delaying me. Let's switch to the point that the spirit can't be patient. If it doesn't find women, it will make a man like a man. It's not normal. These are the spirits behind it. Listen very carefully. That's what happened in the days of Noah. These spirits you see are not weak. They are not foolish. They are not stupid. The moment they find a body, they start manifesting their characteristic. The same way when the Holy Spirit finds a body, all of a sudden, an anointing you shouldn't have. I shouldn't know your name. Where did it come? It's obvious that it's not me. Something has taken charge of my faculties and is revealing to me something that I should not know. Ordinary me, if I stand close to you, maybe if we fight, you will even beat me. But all of a sudden, I will lift my hand and this guy is on the floor now. Is that me? No. The same way, I'm supposed to give you peace ordinarily, but because of the demon spirit in me, when I come near you, your life must scatter. It's not me. Hear me, married people, this is a mistake. People are coming with forces and influences they don't even know. And you find, this is the mistake that prophets make again. Listen carefully, especially if you're in the prophetic here. Because they now look and say, oh, your wife is a witch. She's not a witch. For some reason, she's hosting a habitation of certain spirit beings that are creating an effect. Even her, she will tell you, I don't know why everybody I come near, if it's their business, it dies. If it's everything, it dies. Are you seeing why some of you, the moment somebody comes to say, I love you, I want to go and see your parents, the spirit in him will say, am I not already there? So what do you want to do now? Tragedies. Listen very carefully. Those spirits feed on things and they put in you desires that will continue to feed them while they remain. That's why you can sit down and they will wake you in the night to carry your laptop and type something you should not watch. And you are watching. You hate what you are watching, but the spirit is feeding on it. It is the atmosphere that will keep it there. Your majesty. Your majesty.
Your majesty,
come be a CEO.
are the same spirits that come to you in the dream world. They carry the face of a man. They carry the face of a woman. They carry the face of an object, a loved one. It doesn't matter. They are doing something to you. All of a sudden, you want to give someone a job, and you say, by tomorrow, please come and collect the job. You go to bed. Notice, all of a sudden they have come. The dream will carry different. You may see yourself in primary school, second. It doesn't matter what form it comes. They are still the ones. Listen to me. All of a sudden, they may come and molest you. They may come and do whatever they want to do. And you stand up in the morning. To you, you don't know what happened. You dress very smart. Sir, I've come to collect my employment letter. And the man will say, if I see you here, you had the testimony of our mommy here. How can you tell somebody else? This is what has made many of your helpers to leave you. They will promise you, send me your account. And all of a sudden, you go to bed and those spirits are here. We don't know. The Bible said, lest Satan should take an advantage of you, for we are not ignorant. This is the number one cause of barrenness, number one cause of impotency, the jealousy of those spirits, the very jealousy of those spirits. With all honor to our doctors, I love doctors, but I'm telling you, this is it. Can I surprise you? I want to tell you something that many of you may not believe. I hope and pray that you may believe it. That's why you see, I struggle with tonight's teaching. It is possible for a woman to carry a seed that is for both her husband and these spirits. I wish I'm not the one teaching this. Sometimes this work is very hard. Sometimes it's true. Go back to our villages and hear what our great grandparents with divination used to say. Sometimes they will see a child and stand and say, no, let me look at this child and look at this child and look at this child and say, no, something is wrong. And this child is born with unusual trouble and unusual abilities. Usually doesn't last for too long and just dies and goes. But within that 12 to 15 years, the trouble that that child causes for the family. What can this one is not a deliverance issue. This is another seed that is not human. Can I tell you this? Don't feel bad. We are praying. Don't feel bad. This is how fibroid is formed. What you call fibroid is the aberration of the intercourse between these spirits. Are we together now? An attempt for these spirits. That's why it grows in the same place where a baby should grow. As a baby is growing, it's growing too. And notice that 90% of the time it will kill the baby, yet you say it's not alive. From the womb already. Ask Jacob and Esau. That from the womb, the children were already there. They were already fighting. Ask Jesus and John. You call them, they are just fetuses. Whereas there was communication going on. When Mary met with Elizabeth, the babies too met with themselves. How are you? How are you? We're on our way coming. Oh, I will come before you. Make sure you do it nice. They were interacting. Please sit down. When you know these things, you will appreciate the power of God and the victory of Christ. I know this may look like a messy teaching tonight, but just allow me to tidy this up. And then you will walk back and now find out that nothing just happens. Nothing. Watch this. These demon spirits, till today until Jesus comes, they are searching for bodies to find expression. They are in our fathers. That's why our fathers behave unusually. They are in our mothers. That's why they behave unusually. Wife, that's the mystery behind the stubbornness and your wise decisions of your husband. He may be well-meaning. Notice that most of those people, a time can come, they are calm and understanding and peaceful and cooperative. And then suddenly something comes. when you are bringing someone out of a prison cell, there's a sign here that you will never steal anybody's thing. You will sign and say, I won't do anything. Say, oh yeah, be born again. I will be a serious person. I will even be serious. For the first 2 days, he will go to the farm doing well. Until that spirit now knows there is a stronghold. Are we together? I will teach you this on deliverance. There is already a doorway that allows it. So the spirit goes on vacation. As that brother is in the farm, he will make another person annoy him. Because all these attributes of the flesh are doors. With a simple anger, it returns. It has entered. The guy doesn't know. All of a sudden, the guy gets up and says, you hit me, and beats him and kills him. He's back to the prison. He's wondering, what am I doing on my way back to the prison? The spirit has come back to his house. Because when a spirit leaves a man, it doesn't wave at you. It allows for some time. The frustration of a lack of habitation will make it come back and say, that womb I left, let me go back and find out what is there. Oh, there is a child there now. That home I went, there is joy now. I need a space for myself. And the moment they find expression, they will have to start executing their own attributes. Have you not been surprised? Look at those who steal. If they are under the influence of that demon, hide anything anywhere. The person will stand, is like word of knowledge. He will just look around and say, lift that carpet. You will carry the money there. He doesn't know. It's true. I'm telling you this. You know I'm not lying. You hide the money anywhere. One day you hide it inside the ceiling. He will just stand and look up. The spirit is saying, look up. That's where it is. I know a true story of a couple I counseled some years ago. They were about to get married. All of a sudden, from nowhere, very wonderful lady who loves the Lord. The lady brought a report crying that they said she was positive with HIV. I was surprised, because a lady that I know, very well-behaved lady. I said, what happened? Where did that one come from? And all of a sudden, when I was looking, in the realm of the spirit, God just opened my eyes. And as soon as I touched that spirit, something strange happened. Now, I'm not saying you should go out and create trouble, but something strange happened. The spirit started manifesting and speaking around. And he said, at the point of the test, it entered the doctor. Doctors, you are my friends. Thank God you are born again. We just finished an outreach. There are many things that if we do not know, there are many people carrying reports that are not true. There are many people carrying things that are not true. It is these same spirits that appear. What is HIV? HIV is called AIDS, Abi. Acquired, meaning it's not within you. It came from somewhere. Acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. I hope I'm right. Where do you think it came from? Where do you think cancer came from? When you understand this, you will know why all of a sudden Jacob did something. Do you know, I will be showing you, Jacob slept and had a dream, and Jacob saw where the males that pregnanted the female goats came from. It was in a dream. He looked above and saw that all the males in the realm of the spirit were spotted. It was not Laban's males. No, they came from somewhere. That's why it didn't matter what Laban said. The results were manipulated from the realm of the spirit. When you are assisted from the realm of the spirit, it doesn't matter what the disadvantages are. There is a system to change everything. This is not my discussion this night, but don't tempt me to have to go and show you, please, that these spirit interactions must be there for Satan and demons to find expression. No man just enters trouble like that, and no man just comes out like that. There must be that spirit interaction. Let me show you something. You're tempting me for us to Genesis 30. Let's look at it. Genesis 30, 25. We'll look at 25 to 43. Jesus, thank you. Pray in the spirit, please, while we are opening this. Hallelujah. Look at this. Look at this. Let me talk about Jacob and Laban now. I'm establishing a point here. And it came to pass when Rachel was born Joseph, that Jacob said to Laban, send me away that I may go to my place and my country. We're reading, it's a long reading. Let's see how fast we can go. Just keep projecting and let's go. He said, give me my wives and all of that and all of that. Go to 28. Jacob is discussing with Laban now. And he said, appoint me thy wages and I will give thee. 29. We're reading down to 40 thereabout. And he said, thou knowest that I have served thee and how thy cattle was with me. 30. For it was little which thou hadst before I came, and it is now increased to a multitude. And the Lord had blessed thee. Who blessed thee? Talk to me. Who blessed thee? The Lord has. We'll see how that Lord did the blessing. The Lord had blessed thee since my coming, and now well shall I provide for my own house. 31. And he said, what shall I give thee, Jacob? He said, don't give me anything. If thou will do with this one thing, I will again keep thy flock. What is the one thing? 32. I will pass through the flock today, removing from thence all the speckled and spotted cattle, and all the brown cattle among the sheep, and the spotted and speckled among the goats, and of such they shall be my hire. So he's saying, I will go round your ranch. All the cows and the sheep that are spotted, I will pick them. At this point, they were not many. I hope you know that. And then he says, so shall my righteousness answer for me in time to come, when it shall come for my hire, you know, this and that and that. Everyone that is not speckled or spotted, he was saying that if you find it with me, then take me as a thief. Are you getting the idea now? The Bible says, so Laban said, behold, I would that it might, you know, might be done according to your word. 35. And he removed that day all the goats that were ring straight and spotted and so on and so forth and so forth. Go to verse 40. Go to verse 40. Jacob went on a journey. There's no time to prove it, but you will see that Jacob simply went on a journey for 3 days. Jacob returned back after 3 days and suddenly saw spotted calves. He said, no, something is going on here. The goats and cows and sheep were not pregnant the normal time that goats there, because the males that got them pregnant were not part of the fold. They came from somewhere. The same way the Bible never says Jesus was pregnant for 9 months. No, it's not on record that Jesus was pregnant for 9 months. Jacob did separate the lamb and set the faces of the flocks towards the ring stake. And all, you know, all of this. And he put his own flocks and put them, you know, this and that. 41. And it came to pass, whensoever the stronger cattle did conceive, that Jacob laid the rods before his eyes, the eyes of the cattle in the gutters, that they might conceive among the rods. When we read to 43, we stop there. But when the cattle were feeble, he puts them not in. So the feebler were Laban's and the stronger Jacob's. Last verse 43. Then we'll go to verse 41. And the man increased exceedingly and had much cattle and maid servants and men servants and camels and asses. Now go to chapter 31. Let me search it here. 31 from verse 10 to 13. Genesis 31. Read with me. One to read. And it came to pass at the time that the cattle had gone. I just jumped from verse 1 to 9. Verse 1 to 9 was the frustration of Laban's sons. They started saying, so now Jacob has taken everything. What inheritance do we have? And the Bible is showing us how God assisted Jacob to produce that result. Are you ready? And it came to pass that at the time that the cattle conceived, that I lifted up my eyes and saw where? In a dream. So Jacob was dreaming, and the dream now revealed what was happening that was not there physically. What did he see in a dream? I behold the rams which leaped upon the cattle were ring staked, speckled, and I beheld. I saw in my dream that there were some cattle that were making these ones to be pregnant that were not part of the. Are you with me now? He's not awake, oh, he's seen in a dream. 11. And the angel of the Lord, so the angel was there. We know that there are angels, and other cattle came from another realm. He spoke to me in a dream, And he said, Jacob. And I said, here I am. Verse 12. And he said, lift now thy eyes and see all the rams. An angel is showing him another ram somewhere that is not part of Laban's flock. All they needed was Laban's females. The males came from another realm. The same way all the fallen angels needed was the females of men. The males were the angels with their seed. All the rams which leap upon the cattle are ring-staked, speckled and grizzled. For I have seen. I had to introduce some other animals to come and give you speed of result, because I have seen the wickedness of Laban. So I came to assist you with extraordinary result that is not of this realm. 13. I am the God of Bethel. This is why I'm doing it. Where you anointed with a pillar and where you vowed a vow unto me, he said, arise, get thee out of this land and out of thy kindred. Jacob woke up, and all of a sudden the males were not seen physically, but when the females gave birth, they were all speckled. And Laban said, how did this thing happen? But God said, Jacob, let me show you. So when you see a woman frying akara and building a house with that akara, there is an assistance. It cannot just be about 10,000. No, the realm of the spirit came to assist men. This is a testimony of this ministry. This is a testimony of my life. We are not alone. He sent his angel. There is the angel of his presence. And if you don't believe what I just taught you, the devil will destroy you, and you will never. Now, when you see unusual results, you don't question it, because I have shown you that heaven can assist men. He said, remember the Bethel. I am the God of Bethel. So was that angel an angel? No. I am the God. I came to supervise your speed. I have seen how Laban mocked you. And is it not me that said I will restore? So let me do it now. I will bring my own male cattle from everywhere. Are you seeing why the Bible said the cattle on 1,000 key? Where is it? It's not a location on earth. The cattle, God has it. The next time somebody gets a miracle alert and you are asking, where did the money come from? Does that sound wise? No. Lest Satan should take advantage of us, for we are not ignorant. I have taught you now that the realm of the spirit can assist men. The same way when you see, so that you stop this counseling that doesn't make sense, you see an unusual thief, an unusual troublemaker, a man who marries 11 wives and is not tired, that man does not need counseling. What's the name of that group that used to discipline men? That social group. Social welfare. Even if you like, report him to EFCC. There is a spirit. A normal man should be satisfied with his wife alone. The moment a spirit comes, no. Unusual characteristics, unusual attributes, unusual wickedness. When a man carries a knife and takes one of our little ones here and is slaughtering a baby like this, my brother, my sister, that's not a normal human being. A spirit is using his hands to hold a knife. Remember that when these spirits show up, they are so wicked. Jesus said one of the signs, he says, before the coming of God, it shall be like the days of Noah. That means there will be a repeat of this again. These spirits in an unusual way will multiply wickedness. But the hope is that the power of God too and the assistance from heaven will also be multiplied upon the saints. That means that the revivals that are coming, you will see dimensions of the spirit at work in a man that you have never seen in church history. Spirit. So accidents don't just happen. No. You are just driving and then the car just veers off. My brother, the car did not just veer off. A spirit attempting in frustration to either kill you. Don't feel bad. Don't feel bad whether that happened to your loved ones. So that's why God is teaching us. A pastor can have a ministry And when the ministry wants to rise, because he is ignorant of this, that spirit can enter him, and all of a sudden you will find out that it's 5 months of intense hatred from members. They will hate you for no cause, and the ministry dies. Lest Satan should take an advantage of me. Demons can enter people. Demons can enter homes. They can enter churches. When they enter, they execute the will of Satan. You can be born again, they will not touch your spirit, but I guarantee you, they will come to your mind and build a fortification around your mind and still feel safe as though they were in your spirit, so that your being born again makes no difference as far as you are concerned. This is the mystery behind these things. So you see them in your sleep when you sleep, and you wake up and read, like I shared with you, we have been translated from the kingdom of darkness, and you don't know who to tell. You are sad. Good things want to happen. These wicked spirits come in. Let me tell you, progress and breakthrough is not very difficult. It's the spirits that make it so hard. You are near your breakthrough like this. Do you know these spirits can relocate your destiny helper just so that you will suffer? While men slept, the enemy came with his seed and planted it. Don't feel embarrassed that when you look at your life, you see the outworkings of these seeds. Because I don't know if we have that time now. If we don't have it, we'll do part four after the miracle service. No problem. I don't just want to rush this. You have to appreciate this for me to teach you the dimensions of deliverance. Because casting out a spirit is only one of the dimensions of deliverance. If you stop there, you didn't do well, because the spirit will return. Are we together? If I push this door open and I leave that door open, am I still safe? Please talk to me. That spirit for sure will come back. Their determination to return to you was not left as a secret in the Bible. The Bible is very clear about the fact that if a demon leaves you, it will try to come back. That's why you find out that people can be free for 10 years from poverty, and then 17 years, the spirit now comes. They say, it's been a while, let me come back. A man can be married, loves his wife, after she gives him 3 or 4 children, and then all of a sudden, what he was doing when he was 20, 21 comes back when he's 41. That's why you find out that a man loves God and is walking passionately, and then before you know it, when he's age 55, he will go back into a gay lifestyle or do something, and you are wondering, at 55? The American nation ignored this. Satan proposed a doctrine to the West that exited the issue. He just created a safe zone for himself in our teachings. Notice that Satan didn't remove everything. He just found the hardest part of it and created a theology that keeps him safe. And look at the result today. Listen. Hold on, guys. Let me tell you this. Listen to me. I have been a victim of these things that I'm telling you. If you don't conquer this thing, you will never last. Are you getting what I'm saying now? That's the reason why it looks like no matter how you do well, there's no curse in my life, I am free, I don't have any, no devil, don't talk about any curse to me, the spirit will just keep quiet and be watching you. And all of a sudden, the same way it took your father and rubbished his life, took your mother and rubbished her life, you will suddenly find out that you got married. You find out that you got married. Watch this. And all of a sudden, you will become a replica of your father. A replica. Remember, it started with your father slapping your mother. He said sorry once. Then he did it again. The third time he said, I won't say sorry again. I will give you a dirty slap. I paid your dowry. Now, because you thought you were a pastor, it will leave you just like that. And then you keep managing it for a while. and then after 9 years the demons will make sure it bites you where it is hard, and you turn and give her a slap and find yourself, and two of you will sit down and counsel yourself, say it will never happen, and before you know it you would have done it many times. I'm not telling you this to show you how powerful Satan is. I'm only giving you a sense of appreciation, because deliverance is possible, and complete deliverance is possible. If complete deliverance does not happen to you, you will never possess your possession. Believe me, believe me. This is the Bible. Obadiah 1:17, please give it to us. The sons of Jacob will possess, it is their possession, but there is a mystery. Are you seeing why many of our parents just said, don't worry, I will get the job? For 25 years, they didn't get any other job. 25 years, no other job. No lifting. What of the families where women are the ones who feed the men? If you are a man and you ever try to rise up, those horns will squash you down. When mommy called me, sorry to just make reference to her, I saw her text. The fact that I don't reply your text doesn't mean I don't look at it. When I saw her text, I knew immediately what was wrong. I knew that they were controlling powers that have followed the life of this dear young man. I prayed for him here before he left. And I knew that if God does not help this man, you will be surprised that one day. Are you seeing why people go abroad for 10 years and return back like thieves? You don't hear from them for a long time. You think they've built houses, they are coming to give you money. They return back in shame. They start moving from country to country through deserts to arrive in Lagos. When the young man sent me a text, I looked at it. Somebody gave you a job, and people don't just change their mind. When things just change suddenly, just know that a spirit just came in. The same way, if it can change for the positive, I hate you, but I just change. You know that, this is the Holy Spirit. The Holy Ghost has stepped in. The man, and I called him. How are you, my friend? Said, fine. I said, let's pray. I said, when I pray for you, you are going to get the job. Father, in the name of Jesus, it's not what I'm saying. Jesus said, go. It is what you are standing on. It is not just the articulateness of your words. It is the office and the revelation that backs you. So you can say one word, go. And the demons don't hear go. The demons see all the mysteries that support what you are saying. This is what produces result. Many people think it is in the articulateness of the English. I now, standing by my left, adjure you that you move. No, that is grammar, my brother. Demons don't hear grammar. The revelation, when Jesus said go, go is not enough to take demons away. It was the rock that he was standing on. Two houses were built. It is the rock you are standing on. He said, this is how I will build my church. You will not just speak. It is what you are speaking on that supports your results. When I prayed for that gentleman, I just dropped the phone. I knew what would happen. Because all I did, you would think it is me that produced the result. I know what to tell the Holy Spirit. I know the factor that must be introduced in that equation. I knew that except the angel of the Lord comes to rescue. And because they are always ascending and descending, they confirm the words of his messengers. All I did was to create space for the Holy Spirit. Let there be space for you in this equation. And all of a sudden, he steps in. And I don't know how many hours. I don't think it was up to 3 hours. You see mommy dancing here. She's not just dancing for nothing. That's why you hear somebody say, I just came for koinonia. And the things didn't just change. God will examine your equations and see how you threw him out. And just say, okay, let me be introduced here. And all of a sudden, things change. Things change. I will stop here so that we'll pray. After miracle service, I will teach you now on casting out devils, and I'll teach you deliverance through transformation and the discipline of conformity. All of this will come in. Let's do part 4. Let's not rush this thing. I want us to take some time, hold on, before you stand up, to take some time to pray. It is not a secret that these demons are around. They use all kinds of ways to enter your life, and the flesh is their greatest access. You are alone in the room and you are hearing sounds. Bam! Ceiling. Window looks like it's opening. They are looking for an access point. How can I make this person fear and doubt the faithfulness of God so that I can find expression in his life? You are just hearing like wind is blowing. All of a sudden you imagine somebody has to be near me. And then anger. Have you noticed that every time good things are coming, a good relationship, a brother just comes, just at the point he's about to propose, that week something dangerous happens, you are at your angriest point, and the brother says, no, I can't marry you. Then you return back. These are the spirits playing on the minds of the saints, messing up our breakthroughs. The day you are supposed to go for a job interview, you are running, then your car breaks down. Your car didn't have any business breaking down, but it broke down. As soon as you arrive there, they say, sorry, the gate is closed. So you stand there and say, life, not life, spirits. Spirits, my brother, spirits. They're about to pay your father his gratuity. The demons will hook the money until the day they diagnose him of having cancer, that will spend 150,000 for chemotherapy and the rest. Then the money suddenly comes, and because you have to use it to spend it and spend it and spend it and spend it. How about students that enter the exam hall? They thought they went alone. You conduct tutorials for others and enter the exam hall. As soon as you sit down, you look at the paper. But I solved this question yesterday night. What happened? These demons hijack your understanding. When you are out of the exams, you go back and see the paper in your house that you solved it with. Sometimes you are on your way to the exam to write your final year exam and you forget one question paper in your pocket. You didn't forget. You were assisted to leave it there. All of a sudden, an invigilator comes and says, what is that? Stand up. And said, no, that's it. You are going. Listen to what I'm telling you. Because God delivered me myself, it would be impossible to be doing ministry at this level just talking and saying this. I am a product of the deliverance that happens upon Mount Zion. There are people, there is no good thing you give them that blesses them. Give them money, it will be the reason for their trouble. Help them, give them favor, they will cause trouble. Our loved ones may be like that. For many years, the church has been deceived and misled into thinking everything is just normal, into thinking, oh, everything is fine, I am okay. Just because we have some little money, we allow the devil fool us into believing that we are all right. The devil can allow you to continue being a preacher, keep winning the loss, keep healing the sick, while he hijacks your mind and continues to do what he is doing. At age 12, you see your son already reproducing you, and you are saying, my God, what is this? Brothers and sisters, I tell you the truth by the authority of the word of God. I know that I'll be criticized by many people for these teachings, but let me tell you this. I was called into the office of an apostle. Listen, I share with you a mystery that will help you to possess your inheritance. I will not lie to you and sit you down and allow the devil tear your life into pieces. Let this deliverance be perfected in you. You will be shocked at the things that will happen. You're already hearing testimonies. Job will become child's play. Everything will become child's play. Barrenness stories. There are many of us who would have been in ministry by now. The call of God is upon you. You know the call of God is upon you. But these spirits won't let you rest. They are all around you. They will make sure that every helper God brings to your life, you do something to them that drives them against you. That's why some of us don't have friends. It's not like you are bad. The moment a friend comes to your life, wonderful person. Oh, I love you. I want to help you. The spirits will make something happen. You will betray the person. You will lie against the person. You will do something stupid that will kill your opportunity. And all of a sudden, they will leave you. But tonight, brothers and sisters, the devil is a liar. I don't know if there's someone here who is tired, who is saying enough is enough. I can't let this happen. If you are free, your loved ones are not free. So in any case, there is something for you to do.
Ay, 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 ay. Ebenezer.
I've not yet taught you. The next time we meet, when we now start talking of deliverance, we are going to look at the deliverance ministry of Jesus. Just Jesus. Leave Paul, leave this. Just Jesus. And we are going to see what Jesus did with this spirit. And you will see that Jesus said, this kind goeth not. There is a kind. You don't just generically tell demons go. No. There are different spirits. The way you drive a fallen angel from influencing a life is not the same way you cast out a demon. Now, the fallen angels may be illegal occupants, but the demons are legal occupants. They came by birth. The women gave their wombs freely. So they are not just run. No, they have a right. This kind goeth not. This kind goeth not. This kind goeth not. Listen, I shared with you during the prayer and fasting, remember, that there is a physical atmospheric temperature that drives demons by itself. There are places on earth that demons cannot stay. There's no preacher there. The environment itself drives them. It's in your Bible that when a demon leaves a man, it goes through where? Dry regions, hoping it will find something dry that it and not finding any. It's uncomfortable and it comes back. Who casted it from that place? Nobody preached to it. It left that place and preferred to come and fight you than to remain in the wilderness. Listen, witchcraft was a proposition that these spirits brought to men. Men are not so smart to know that you should kill somebody. There are wicked people from where we come from that will exchange the life even of their children for themselves. Have you seen old people who don't die? Every time they are sick, you hear that someone is dead and then they are alive. All of a sudden they become fine. No, sir. Read in the Bible, a king who slew his son to keep his own life. Nobody will bring a knife to my neck to keep it. We are going to pray. It's just going to be praying in tongues now. I want you to find a corner, my brother, my sister. Take your life serious. In the next 5 minutes, instrumentalists just charge the atmosphere for us. Blast in tongues and refuse upon Mount Zion. And it shall come to pass in that day. And it shall come to pass in that day. In that day. In that day. That the burden shall be taken from off your shoulder. And the yoke from off your neck. And it shall be destroyed because of the anointing. Please pray, pray. Pray. If you are tired, hold the hands of somebody that can agree with you. Shabakatakatos. Seketeketekete. Shabrakatokatopakata. Pray. your destiny. Pray, enough is enough, oh God. The victory of Christ, the work of Jesus on the cross, cannot be in vain. The substitutionary sacrifice of the Son of the Living God cannot be in vain.
Pray.
That burden shall be taken from off my shoulder. That yoke from off my neck. Enough is enough in the name of Jesus. Shabatakata. Shabatakata. Shabatos kabarota senevetas. Embreketekete. Shepos soto baruka. Embrakato shabarakata yadavarabas. Shatos solekete meneketa. Pray, Koinonia. Pray for your family. Pray for your wife. Pray for your husband. Pray for your children. Arise, oh God. This is Bethel. This is Bethel. This is Bethel. Arise, oh God of Bethel. Pray. Pray. Shabbat, oh Shabbat. It's time to move forward. It's time to move forward. It's time to break grounds in the spirit. It's time for the anointing of your destiny to come. It's time for the ministry to open. It's time for your finances to come. It's time for prophecy to find expression.
Elohim Adonai, thy kingdom come, thy will be done. Elohim Adonai, thy kingdom come, thy will. Elohim Adonai,
Elohim Adonai,
Elohim Adonai,
thy will be done.
Elohim Adonai.
Hallelujah. We are going to pray. This prayer is a serious prayer. As we pray, sisters, I want you to lay your hands on your womb. As we are praying, brothers, just pray in tongues. I'd like you to declare that no seed of any entity that is not of God will find. I will not give birth to any stranger. No. Lekatoskata barata. Shanakatoskata. Pray. No matter the ordinances of the fathers, no matter the enchantments of the ancient, I come by a new order and I declare my womb will produce that seed of the woman that will bruise the head of the serpent. I cause fibroid. I cause fibroid. Cause every devil. Shabatata. Shakatakatakata. Lekatakate. Mambrakos kotope rekete. Eshekatekatekatekate. Rapakatoprekateliata. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We are going to pray. Brothers, I'd like you to pray. The spirit that keeps men in one place. You don't move forward, you don't move backward, you stay, no productivity. Every gentleman here, open your mouth and blast in tongues. Father, rend the heavens. This is Bethel. Shabata katoskata. The yokes, the altars, and everything that tie my life, that tie my destiny, by the mystery of deliverance, I challenge. It is upon Mount Zion, the spirits that cause failure. Shaka toka pech. Ete preke teke teke to shake te. Hallelujah. Listen. Demons came into being when the spirit assisted men. So your victory comes into being when the spirit assists you. It says, I am the God of Bethel. I have seen the oppression that Laban has done. The victory will not just happen. Forget about the physical things. In the realm of the spirit, you are going to cry for divine assistance. I provoke the ministry of angels over every affair of my life. Lift your voice and pray. Cry. Are they not ministering spirits? Are they not ministering spirits? My brothers and sisters, are they not ministering spirit sent to minister for them that be the heirs of salvation? I call for assistance from heaven. Oh God of Jeshurun, the helper of men, the lifter of men, the helper of men, the lifter of men, the deliverer. Shakatos Kataba, angels on assignment. Angels on assignment. Angels on assignment. Angels on assignment. Judging the wicked. Delivering the prophecy of God concerning my life. Hallelujah. We are going to pray. Every attribute of the flesh that gives access to any spirit in my life, by the mystery of the blood, I declare that that door is closed forever. Lift your voice and pray. Come on. Lift your voice and pray. Hallelujah. We are still praying.
I tell you, I feel fire in this place. Listen, everything God has shown you, either as a revelation from his word or as a revelation from the realm of the spirit, you are going to declare. Jacob did not just see the spotted calves and left them in the realm of the spirit. They had to come and interact. The word must become flesh. I'd like you to lift your voice and cry. Jacob's katabata. Every anointing, every mantle, every mandate, every dimension, the prophetic, the apostolic, prosperity, increase, speed, deliverance that God has shown me. Lord, you showed me victory. I declare, it must find expression. Pray.
Hallelujah. Now, this prayer we're going to pray, listen carefully. Whether you're an usher or not, please, if anyone is under the anointing or manifesting around you, just help them. Are we together? It's a very serious prayer we're going to pray now. You're going to pray that if by any means there is any spirit entity in my life or around me, it's time for you to come out. It's time for you to go. Listen, as you pray this prayer, many strange things will start happening to you. Don't worry about it. You just focus on this prayer and pray with all your heart and watch what happens. Say in the name of Jesus. Say it in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare by the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ that any spirit entity finding expression in my mind, in my body, around my life, hear the word of the Lord. I cast you out of my life now. Lift your voice and pray. Shabakatakato. Pray, fire is falling. Pray, fire is falling. Shabatakata. I cast every spirit. I cast every devil. I cast every spirit by the power of the Holy Ghost. My mind, my body, around my life, around Koinonia, in the name of Jesus, around my family, Shamakatos Kadabash. If you are married, also pray for your family. Pray for your children. I cast every devil. Matakota Shamalata. Shabras Katavareketo Shayalamakata. Spirit, in the name of Jesus, there's no place for you in my mind, there's no place for you in my life. I come against ordinances. Oh. Lord is healing fibroid. I'm seeing the Lord healing now. The Lord is healing fibroid. The Lord is healing fibroid. In the name of Jesus, I command that devil. The Lord is healing fibroid. Now, the Lord is ministering to me. A mighty deliverance is going to happen now. It's starting with ladies. Any spirit entity that comes in the form of a man and attempts to oppress you in the night, right now in the name of Jesus Christ, let the fire from heaven fall right now and command. I command that spirit to go. Help them right now. Any spirit entity using the face of anyone to molest you and close doors, shabakato shabaratata shiabakata, inside, outside, I command deliverance now. I command deliverance now. Let the daughters of Jacob possess their possession in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. I'm hearing in my spirit uncontrolled anger. It's a spirit. It's leaving people right now. Uncontrolled anger is an unusual anger. Rage. It comes, you can tear anything and you can do anything. I'm seeing fire in the name of Jesus. Shakatos kabarakatos emeyakata. Anyone who is a victim of this operation, right now in the name of Jesus, I bring you deliverance. I bring you deliverance by the power of the Holy Ghost. Uncontrolled anger, I come against it now. Please help her. Shatas kotaba shatariasa. Embrakatos sabarokatos shekete balakaya. I'm seeing a vision and the Lord is asking me to pray on that case. In this vision, I'm seeing someone dream. That's what I'm seeing now. And in that dream, you keep seeing yourself going back either to your old house or to a primary school or writing an exam you are finished. It's a strong spirit of delay. I stand by this apostolic and prophetic grace. Help your wife. Right now in the name of Jesus, at the count of three, the spirit of delay, hear the word of the Lord. Let God's people go now. 1, 2, 3. I command that spirit, go now, go now. Please help them, go now. This one thing I do, forgetting the things that are behind. No devil should take you back again. I command that spirit, go now. I curse that spirit now. If there is anyone you know, whether you are here or anyone you know, that for some reason has not been able to take in the name of barrenness, whether you are here or you are standing for them, I want you to agree, I want to pray. Let's see the devil that will stop them from taking it. In the name of Jesus, anyone you know and you are standing for, that the devil, I don't care what the medical report is, that the devil has come to make sure that they will not celebrate children. In the name that is above all names, we release children from heaven. In the name of Jesus, we release children from heaven. We open every barren womb. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. The Lord is showing me a group of people. You see, you have dreams frequently, and in the dreams you see yourself receiving things, and it's something that in the physical you are hoping to receive, But the moment you see it in that dream, it will never happen again. It's an irony. It's like the opposite of what you see in dreams is what happens. The Lord is asking me to deliver those people now. Please help her. Help her. Just stand near your wife so that she doesn't have to fall. Right now, in the name of Jesus, shakatos, emprantas kanasone hashamaria kata, shakraskote bakatosa barekata, eko shamama shanada kata, rekete kete kete, eskamara katos kaba, zatia 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 shekene kosha, brakatos karikata. In the name that is above all names, I decree and declare from the realm of the spirit, let there be deliverance for you now. Let there be deliverance for you now. Just two more points and we're done. Look at me. If you have seen this pattern I'm about to describe in your family, then I want you to listen carefully. It's always that the future is worse than the past. You never have a situation where you leave certain things and go higher and higher. You look at all your loved ones, they once walked, they once married, they once had children, they once had a house. You are in a situation where the future is never brighter than the past. It's always once upon a time this was happening. I need to crush that devil from your life. Please help them. Once upon a time, I was rich. Once upon a time, I was married. Once upon a time, I was on fire for God. Once upon a time, I was a pastor. I had a church. No, the path of the just is as a shining light that shineth ever brighter unto the perfect day. When your tomorrow becomes worse than your yesterday, there is a spirit reversing the equation. Lift your hands, I want to pray for you. In the name that is above all names, I declare that any force from hell that is responsible for aborting a glorious tomorrow, to take the events of the past and still bring it into your tomorrow, right now at the count of three, I declare that spirit must let you go. One, sha-da-da-da-da-da-da. Two, three, let them go now. Let them go now by the anointing of the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Please just be patient with me. We'll end now. My spirit is heavy. Circles of repeated sicknesses. I want to pray now. It's not a normal thing. Whether it is hepatitis, whether it is a blood-related disease, or whether it is every month malaria, every month malaria, every month typhoid, you treat it, it still comes back. Every month headache, every month whatever it is. Hold on, please. The Lord is showing me something. I just saw like a pile of money and then I saw it disappear. And the Lord said there are people, money physically disappears, like lives their life. I'm not saying you waste it. You can keep 10,000 and come back and find 7,000 and nobody was in that house. It's not just money, items. You can wash clothes and hang it. You didn't steal it. You will come back, you will not find it. Listen, well, this is a deliverance series. Just allow me to help that lady. I'm seeing a lady in a vision now. You were alone. You washed your underwear in the night. By the next day, you didn't find two of them again. It's gone. From that day, something happened in your life in a strange way. Severe menstrual pain is one of the things you started having. Uncontrollable pain. In the name of Jesus. Everything the devil has taken from anyone, I decree and declare by the anointing of the Spirit, let there be restoration now. Let there be restoration now. Let there be restoration now. The Lord is showing me someone. Every time you see someone die in the dream, a few weeks later it will happen physically. Now you have seen your loved ones. You saw them last week. You saw like somebody was announcing to you that, I don't know if it's your mother or something that died. If we don't pray for you, it's going to happen. In the name of Jesus Christ, I declare, oh death, where is thy sting? Oh grave, where is thy victory? I prophesy right now upon your life. Shabakato kasada malakata. By the anointing of the Holy Ghost, I command that death to pass over your family. I command that death to pass over your family. Hallelujah. Just let me just talk about two issues. I'm struggling to share what God is showing me now. This has to do with a group of ladies. Listen. There is a lady here. Every time you see yourself in a dream, you are a man, not a woman. That's why I'm struggling to share what I'm saying. Physically, you are a lady, but every time you see yourself in a dream, it's like you are carrying the form of a man. This thing has affected you even in the area of relationship. If a guy looks at you and says, I love you, it's like you feel as if you are gay. It's like something has numbed the capacity to receive love as a lady because of that encounter. It's a demonic thing that I have to pray for you for. A very demonic thing. I'm seeing like smoke. This is strange. And then it's just like moving around in the air. Wherever those groups of people are, I don't believe it's just one person. It's an operation of darkness. In the name of Jesus, I stretch my hands right now. And I decree and declare by the power of the Holy Ghost, be free from that demonic siege now. Be free from that demonic siege now. Hold on. There is a lady, a physical person appeared to you. Not a dream. I'm not talking of your dreaming. Physical, like you are seeing me like this, appeared to you and was having a conversation with you. Appeared to you and was having a conversation with you. And from that conversation, your life was never the same again. It looked like it was a woman that was appearing and talking to you. Like revealing to you some secrets that had to do with the past. And from that day, you've started hearing voices, even in the afternoon. You can sit down and hear like people are discussing. I need to pray for you. If I don't pray for you, very soon they will admit you in the hospital because they will say you are talking and behaving like somebody who has a psychosomatic condition. Wherever that person is, in the name of Jesus, I may not call you out because of time, but I declare right now, by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, that devil, that spirit, in the name of Jesus, be free from it now. I was going to pray for repeated cycles of sickness. Let that be the last. Let's pray. If you know in this place that you find out that certain sicknesses never leave you, they keep repeating cycles, just place your hand on your chest. I'm about to pray. It doesn't matter what part of your body and what sickness, you just place your hand on your chest. I'm going to pray. Someone will shout under the anointing. When that happens, the anointing for this healing, is not a sickness, it's a pattern that God is breaking now. The moment that shout happens, I will rebuke that, and then we're done for the night. We will continue the miracle service. I'll talk about it shortly. Thank you, Jesus. Just lay your hands there. The power of God is looking for one person. There's somebody that will shout. That's the shout. Right now, in the name of Jesus, by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, every pattern of reoccurring infirmity, reoccurring sickness, whether it's a blood-related disease, every pattern, I say it again, of reoccurring sickness, reoccurring disease, right now, by the power of the Holy Ghost, I command the spirit responsible, lose your hold now. 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 Hallelujah. In this series, I gave you an instruction. Our time is gone. I want to give you another one now. Please listen very carefully. I told us we have been doing it. I know a number of you may not have been so faithful. Just try to be consistent. Do it out of revelation. At least 15 minutes in the night, wake up and pray. Pray in the spirit. Declare the victory of Christ. Just forget about whatever dream or whatever experience you're having. Just do what I'm asking you to do. Are we together now? The next meeting we're going to be having here is a miracle service. Listen, I'm taking our time. Our miracle service will not be on Friday. Listen carefully. Our miracle service will be on Monday. Are you getting what I'm saying now? Not this Friday, not this Saturday, not this Sunday, on Monday. Please listen. On Friday, you're going to fast. On Saturday, everybody, you're going to fast. Are we together? At least, if you cannot do to 6, minimum at least to 12. And that, I believe, it should even be our little children. Any adult here should at least be able to reach 12 or 2. You will not die. So Friday, you are fasting. Saturday, you are fasting. Are we together? Sunday, you are fasting. I want you to come on Monday. The miracle service, we are going to start by praying for the sick so that we'll finish that. It's going to be a night of intense deliverance. Intense. Anybody you truly love, even if it's your loved ones, no matter where they are, if they can find their way, please come. Medical reports, bring it. All these threat letters, whatever, just bring it. And let's cry to the God of heaven to arise and work wonders here. The plague of death, you can collect as many people's prayer requests. Even if they cannot come, just collect it. We are going to take at least 30 minutes to just agree and pray in tongues and charge the atmosphere when we come. Are we together? It's a prayer, it's a prophetic, it's a strong deliverance meeting. The Lord put that in my heart. So please listen. I'm saying it, this media, please take note, including those outside. Friday, you are fasting. Just break on your own. You don't have to come here. Or if you have your little friends, you can just meet and pray and sleep. Be very spiritual. It's not when you should go to somebody's house and you are disturbing them. It's a week of spiritual emphasis. We are trusting God to push through, that Jericho, that Dagon must fall once and for all. Friday, you are fasting. Please don't let food cheat you. You don't die if you don't eat for a few hours. Saturday, you are fasting. Sunday, you are agreeing you are fasting. Monday, you can eat and do whatever. I'd like you to come here prayerfully and come here spiritual. From the opening prayer to the praise and worship, participate with all your heart. Are we together? By the grace of God, we'll make it the miracle service. But I will see the possibility. If because of time we cannot make it both a communion and anointing service, then I'll be patient. The week that follows, as we round up the series, then we'll do it. but we must combine it. It must be a communion service and then an anointing service, when I'll be teaching you now the forces of deliverance and the rest. But this miracle service on Monday, I believe with all my heart, for God to have given this message, He's going to do something strange. So it's not Friday, it's not Saturday, it's not Sunday, it's on Monday. But you fast on Friday, fast on Saturday. If you have loved ones, those are connecting, it doesn't matter what nation of the world, if they care to follow, they can follow in fasting and prayer. Are we together? Now, let me give you the instructions on how to pray. Am I boring you? Am I wasting your time? On Friday, because we have to pray with intelligence. Some of these anyhow prayers we do is what wastes our fasting. We just fast and pray and talk to ourselves and we don't get anything from it. Are we together? If you can write, please write. And please write and do it. On Friday, your entire prayer for that Friday is the mercy of God. Write it. That's all. That's all you are praying throughout Friday by the grace of God. Just follow me. I'm giving you an instruction in righteousness. This is not religion. The only prayer, look for scriptures that talk about the mercies of God. You are praying the mercy of God on your life, on your family. Please just try to follow this instruction. Just do as I'm teaching you. By God's grace, I will not mislead you. From all through your prayer, you are invoking the mercy of God. His mercies are new every morning. Lord, your mercy upon my life. Lord, your mercy upon my past. Lord, your mercy upon my family. I cry and I receive your mercy upon my ministry. Don't go and start saying, oh God, the other day you said you were going to give me tea and bread. No, just leave all that one. Friday, the mercy of God. Are we together? Saturday is intense warfare. Intense warfare. You are going to take out time to pray and challenge the gates. Write down a list of all the things that constitute a challenge in your life. Whether it is delay, whether it is whatever, write it down. You are going to pray warfare. There are many koinonia messages that you can get that relates to that. You can play along if you want and pray. Intense warfare. That means that as much as possible, aside from a few things that you maybe like school of ministry that will be having lectures, if you don't have anything doing, please discipline yourself. This carelessness sometimes is why the devil prevails over us. Find somewhere, beg your friend to give you access to his room or one corner. Go to one forest somewhere, just stay somewhere and pray your life out. Pray against patterns and everything you have seen. Lord, this is what has happened, but I'm standing by the power of the Holy Spirit. So Friday, you are invoking the mercy of God. Saturday, you are dealing with patterns and you are dealing with all of this. On Sunday, all you are doing is thanksgiving. That's all you are doing. You are thanking Him for everything, for His mercies. You can thank Him and praise Him in a dance. You can thank Him and pray. Just play worship, praise Him, whatever you have to do. And then on Monday, come with your heart. Write that Egyptian that has followed you and carry them and bring them here with you. And let the God of Bethel arise for us on Monday. So Friday, we are praying the mercy of God. Don't forget. Go and do the assignment yourself. Scriptures, look for scriptures. Go on Google and all of that. Use different references. Saturday is warfare. Saturday is not praise and worship. Saturday is not thanksgiving. Saturday you are engaging the victory of Christ. Mention situations one by one and take time to pray. Are we together? And then Sunday, spend time singing, dancing, celebrating and thanking God. And then on Monday we are back. Please, for our online community media, make sure you remind us on Thursday or Friday, remind us on what to do. Let's know. You can put a media montage or whatever it is. You can add scriptures that can help us. I could give you a few scriptures so that you guide us. You can follow on Facebook and Twitter. We'll be keeping you updated. We'll be posting and all of that. Ask your loved ones. I know some will say, get out, all these things I'm not doing, don't fight them, just leave them. But as many, they may not be able to make it on this ground, but wherever they are around the world, ask them to connect and also follow, and you watch what God will do. I'm leading you through the same way God led me to be free. Exactly the instruction God gave me and the things I did is what I'm introducing you to. By the time I do the last series of the teaching, you will know why I give some of these instructions. Are we together? Father, we give you all the praise tonight. You are God, and there is none like you. We submit to your wisdom. We submit to your grace. And Lord, I know that you have not called the seed of Jacob to seek you in vain. You have enlightened our minds tonight. And Lord, I thank you, because even by your spirit, there will be a performance in our lives. Lord, even from tonight, let your people begin to enjoy strange breakthroughs. In the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, this is a week of deliverance. I pray that you end age-long captivities once and for all from our lives. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. I want to give someone an opportunity here to give his life or her life to Jesus Christ. You are here. You heard me preach. You heard the word of God come expressly. And you are saying, man of God, I need to make my ways right. Please don't be distracted. I know we are rounding up. Let's not distract those who want to give their life to Jesus. You are at Overflow 3, Overflow 2, Overflow 1, the main auditorium, and those connected online. You are saying, Apostle, that nature that needs to be replaced, that miracle has not happened to me. Or you are saying, Apostle, I love Jesus, but at one point or the other, things have gone haywire in my life, and I need to make my ways right. Please, wherever you are, I don't want you to be ashamed. Please clear the way. Please clear the way. All of you standing at the way, please clear the way. Clear the aisles for them. Wherever you are, you want to make this decision, I want you to boldly get up and come right now, very quickly. Very quickly. If there is anyone, there has to be someone who is saying, man of God, I'm handing my life to Jesus. If you are outside, please clear the way for them as they come. Don't be ashamed. Make your way to the front right now. Make your way to the front right now. There's someone coming. Make your way to the front. If you are coming, Overflow 3, you can just walk to your projector stand. But Overflow 1, Overflow 2, and the main auditorium, make your way to the front. There has to be someone the Spirit of God is speaking to. Let's appreciate them. Don't be ashamed. Be bold. Rise up. Walk. Make your way and come to Jesus. Are there people like that? Clear the way for them outside. Hallelujah. Please clear the way for them. I still believe someone is coming. There has to be someone. If you're coming, God bless you. Come quickly. Join them. Join them quickly. Those coming from the overflow outside, quickly. Please hurry up. If you're coming, rush quickly. 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 Hallelujah. God bless you. If you're joining them, come quickly. Thank you for this great decision. I want you to lift your right hand high to heaven and say this from the depth of your heart. God bless you, my brother. If you're coming, my dear, come quickly, quickly, and join them. Say, Lord Jesus. Say after me, passionately say, Lord Jesus, I love you and I believe in you, that you are the Son of God. Tonight, I have heard your word. And I declare that Jesus is Lord of my life. I declare that from today, I am a child of God. I'm born again. The life of Jesus is at work in me. I declare that the grace to walk in victory is mine now. In Jesus' name. Father, I thank you for these ones. They have come. And they have made this decision for you. Let this decision last in their life. Oh, look at this little child, adorable child. Come, my dear. go to that man. Just go to that man. He will lead you to Christ. That man sitting with a baby, he will help you. Father, thank you. Let this decision be real in their lives. They will never be the same. Forward ever, backward never. Even as you have prayed, I crush every workings of darkness over your life. And I declare they are gone from your life now and forever. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Thank you for this decision. Please follow this gentleman. There are people waving their hands. I'd like you to follow all of them. This one under the anointing, just carry him. Follow them. Everyone, please appreciate them very quickly. Hallelujah.
Dearly beloved, I hope you were blessed by this message. I want you to keep doing something for this man of God, our man of God, Apostle Joshua Selman. And that is, I want you to keep on praying for him, that the cause of the gospel may have free flow in him, that he may be granted boldness to continue with his commission of Jesus Christ, and that all provisions be given unto him as he continues in this journey of Christianity. And then, don't forget to like this video. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button if you are new here. Don't also forget to leave a comment in the comment section, and then keep sharing abroad, and let's all keep sharing Jesus. I'll see you again. Bye.